What is up, guys? Dashing here for episode 216 of Saturday Night Genesis. I got that wrong. 216 of Community Universe Mode in edition number 44 of Saturday Night Genesis. What's better than a botch right off the bat? That's when you know it's going to be a stellar five-star stream here tonight. Hello, Zach. But indeed, it is Genesis. The final stretch before we begin our solid month build to the grandest stage of them all, Ascendance. Going to be just 4 weeks away. I hope you guys are as extremely excited as I am. The card is already absolutely stacked. You are not late, Maury. Just started the stream with a cheeky little botch. Like I said, that's how you know it's going to be an amazing episode full of strokes and spasms. But kicking off the show here tonight, we do have a Tornado Tag Team Anarchy Rules bout to see which of these two duos will earn a spot in the Tag Team Turmoil match at Ascendance, which we now know will be for the Tornado Tag Team titles after the Fast and the Furious defeated the Briggs family on Fusion, Champs versus Champs. And of course, we knew that the losing team would have to defend their belts in the Turmoil, while the winning team would challenge for the title. So we have the Briggs family defending the Fast and the Furious as one of the five challenging teams. We're going to find out who's going to join them here tonight, the Republic or the League of Dudes. This is actually a rematch from a couple nights ago at a live event where the ref called a no contest after Wonder Dude got counted out in ring. Johnny Sampson would get me on the phone and he'd say, nah, that's not how people are going to earn their spots around here. So there's going to be a rematch here tonight on Genesis. And to ensure there are no countouts again, we don't get another fluke ending. He made it Tornado Tag Team Anarchy Rules, which all of the bouts will be at Ascendance. All five matches, of course, there's going to be five challenging teams in the champions. There'll be five eliminations. And every single one of the matches will be Tornado Tag Team Anarchy Rules. And these two do have a great history in this type of match. We know that last month, leading up to Purgatory, these two were in the tournament to crown the first annual champs, and they were beaten by Foreign Affairs. I think it was maybe 2 minutes, maybe even 1 minute, like 50 seconds, that Foreign Affairs beat these guys in this type of match. So the League of Dudes probably got to be your pick going into this. The Republic, technically, though, did defeat League of Dudes at the live event, but Johnny Sampson was having none of it. Big night of action got coming our way here. As always, action packed to the brim and a lot of announcements to get to as well. Too sweet me, baby. Hello, Batman. Oh, drifted. The Irish-born Republic awaiting the dudes. Here we go. Chat along with me. Dude, 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 dude. Oh, yeah, the greatest entrance in CMB history. These guys only a couple of weeks in CMB, and they're already fan favorites, have one of the most over chants probably we've ever seen. And look at the athleticism of Mighty Dude. The back fat just flying through the air. Here we go. Dude, 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 dude. Wonder Dude likes to keep it going a little bit longer than his pal there. Mighty Dude ain't so into it. Here we go. Tornado Tag Team Anarchy Rules. All four men active at the same time. First team to gain pinfall or submission will advance to Ascendance. Be entered into that Tag Team Turmoil match for a chance to become the Tornado Tag Team Champion. Certainly the odds are not in the favor of the Briggs family. Of course, you know the entrance of teams is random, so Briggs family could get lucky, enter last, or they could get not so lucky and enter first. But you know, back at Ascendance 2, we saw X-Gen defend their belts. I think they came in fourth, and they went on to defeat the three other teams that would come out after them to retain their belts. They beat four teams on that night to retain their championships. So don't count out the Briggs family just yet. I'm not saying they're, well, Quantum likes to think that they're technically X-Gen, so hey, you know, anything can happen. Oh, steel steps by the little man right to the face. of Melvin O'Houlihan as McCauley is going ham with that metal bat right down to the quad of poor Mighty Dude. And now he's got the bat again. This is how they did it back in Ireland. He doesn't know which he wants, the bat or the steel chair here. As WD just keeps going ham with the steel steps. He probably doesn't have enough stamina, but he keeps trying to pick up the steps.
I almost wonder if his bell got seriously wrong there.
I wonder if that's a compliment he's ever heard before. Hey, Mighty Dude, you got some strong-looking thighs, man. Nice German by the man who debuted many months ago, defeated Quantum, and then left. Just returned earlier this month alongside his new protege, his sidekick, Wonder Dude. The Republic not doing so well right now at the hands of League of Dudes. Ooh, soccer ball kick right to the spine of poor O'Houlihan. As I said though, guys, action-packed night coming our way. Our main event is gonna see a rematch between the Moo Moo Man, Randy Borton, and the unpredictable Justin Sane, a rematch from last month, and what about that was. Hopefully they can pull it off again. Can't wait to see it. We're also getting a rematch from 2 weeks ago on Fusion between the former Vixens champion, the Urban Warrior Fury, and America's sweetheart, the number one contender to Quinn Bell's Vixens title, Jade Devine. Tonight we also see Double J Jackson Jordan in action. He goes toe-to-toe with the hypothetical kung fu practitioner Kevin Lee. Gonna see if Lee can do what his blood brother Tim couldn't last week on Genesis and defeat the two-time international champion. Much more to come in our way. Two coming our way. As O'Houlihan, I think he's trying to win by count out here, but there's no count outs in a Tornado Tag Anarchy rules match, so he's kind of just chilling. Maybe he's waiting for Mighty Dude to enter because it's not false count anywhere. I think McCauley might have gone for his finisher right there. I'm not sure though. Nice hip toss by the big man. Cold cocking, driving that big old gut right down onto his knee. Oh, is he going for his finisher? No, he's tricking us. Thought he was going to go for that cold cock gourd buster variation. Oh, here's those cheeky jabs, winding up that last one. Wapa! Might be done for here as Wonder Dude's preoccupied with Melvin on the outside. One, two, three! And the Republic once again defeat League of Dudes, but this time they do it legitimately as Melvin trash talks Wonder Dude right in front of him. A cheeky combination of blows sees the Republic qualify for the tag team turmoil match at Ascendance. Look at that. Bam! And Mighty Dude is out cold. It was pretty hardcore, to be fair. I did not see these guys winning after their last performance in a Tornado Tag Team Anarchy Rules match. But the Republic are the third team verified for the Turmoil at Ascendance. They'll meet the Briggs family defending their belts, and of course, the Fast and the Furious, three other teams to qualify. Who's going to make it? We know that next week on Monday Night Fusion, it'll be Doom. Hannibal and Parker taking on the Bromancers in a qualifying match. And up next, we're going to see two guys we have not laid our eyes on since Purgatory, where they both suffered their respective losses. Morgan Jackson, the loss of his international championship to Chris Andrews, and Xander Slate, despite attacking his former friend and protege, Jacob Ziegler, from behind, would taste two swift pedigrees, the hands of Ziegler, and lay down for the 1-2-3, and they return tonight, try to gain some momentum, as they are the two first men announced for the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal at Ascendance in 4 weeks' time. Morgan Jackson and Xander Slate, certainly two big names. course, honoring the spirit of Slick B. Papa Bless, rest in peace, we love you. And certainly whoever wins that 20-man over-the-top rope battle royal will get a huge boost of momentum going into the new year. Well, new year calendar-wise. Tops Newsom did get mentioned in a promo. Actually, I'll mention that right now. It was actually on Fusion 6 nights ago that we finally saw Nick Blake and Billy Weaver back at it again since their match at Purgatory. And Nick Blake was escorted by an army of security guards as he went to the ring and said he's tired of Billy Weaver relentlessly coming after him. We went over it on the last episode on Fusion itself during the stream, but if you missed it, Billy actually went to England, tracked down where Nick Blake lives, went into his house and beat the shit out of him, destroying his TV, his couch, his table, his fridge, drinking all of his beer, eating all of his turkey, and then finally pissed in his pool and then threw him in there. Oh, thank you, Zach. But Nick Blake would come out and say he is done with Billy Weaver. He wants nothing to do with him. Billy better stay away or else, you know, he'll get some of the massive security guards he had with him. And of course, Blake saying, I refuse your challenge for a rematch at Ascendance. Billy would come out, talk some trash on the ramp. The two would exchange back and forth. Billy looking like he was about to take on the security guards when Johnny Sampson would come out and say that although Nick Blake is correct about, you know, Billy being way out of line, going to his home and brutally assaulting him, and that yes, the cops were after him, but Johnny Sampson saying he's got some pull, he's got some connections, got Billy a deal. So Johnny Sampson said there will be a rematch at Ascendance between the two, but that if Billy so much as spits in Nick Blake's direction until Ascendance, the match will be off and Billy will be sent back to jail. But that's not the only announcement Sampson made. He said that Nick Blake was correct in saying that Billy is an animal who should be locked up in a cage. And so that's just what will happen, as at Ascendance, it will be Nick Blake versus Billy Weaver inside of a steel cage, ladies and gentlemen. Johnny Sampson saying he doesn't want the fans to be in harm's way, nobody ringside, anybody in the back. That match is going to end the rivalry one way or another, says Sampson. Nick Blake, Billy Weaver inside of a steel cage at Ascendance as Xander Slate makes his way out here, ready for battle against Morgan Jackson. This certainly has the... what's the word I'm looking for? Has the ability, I guess, to be a great match. Xander Slate, I am the fans there. The dirtiest heel in CMB history. The former Glammy Award winner for Heel of the Year. As Morgan Jackson gonna catch Xander right out of the gate with a clothesline, or an Irish whip, should I say. I've got an idea, Batman. I'll talk to you after the stream. But I got an idea for that.
And the tie-up, make no mistake about it. This is all about skill, determination, and power.
And we're watching human gridlock here. No one will budge.
There may be no Xander Slate getting his arm caught here. Oh, nice trip up. Xander didn't like that very much. Morgan Jackson, again, we have not seen him since Purgatory. We lost his international championship to Chris Andrews. Andrews, in his own right, coming off a victory over Kevin Lee just 6 nights ago on Monday Night Fusion. An amazing bout. Just got beat up for sure by the 2 out of 3 falls match between Jacob Ziegler and Sushi X. If you did not see that, I highly recommend you go and look at it and see a new champion crowned, as Sushi X, after nearly 4 years of chasing the Anarchy title, finally has it around his waist. What a match it was, as Ziegler is no longer the Anarchy champion. Reign ended at 93 days. But tonight, Kevin Lee will try to recuperate from that loss against Chris Andrews. He takes on Double J Jackson Jordan, who's been undefeated since returning at Purgatory. See if you can do what Timmy Boy the Timpster could not last week, even though it was an amazing match. Got match of the week. Maybe Jackson Jordan and Kevin Lee can beat out Ziegler versus Sushi. You just hit register at the top of the site, Just Believe. You make an account. It takes like 2 minutes tops. And then you remember the site. Bam, boom, bazinga. What a ba. Ta-da. Digging the knee into the kidneys there. Front headlock now by the OG, who's been in control since the very start. Snapmare off the ropes. Big boot right to the temple. A match still to come our way here tonight on Genesis Guys as well. I think it might be up next. I'm not sure. It might be later on in the night. But the third and hopefully final encounter that I pray out for Azrael's sake as the Boa goes toe-to-toe with Headhunter once again. This time, no holds barred. Headhunter has beaten Azrael twice before, but the newcomer just refuses to let it go. Now, I fear that tonight may be his last night in CMD. His career is going to be cut short. A promising career for the young upstart. Goes for a slap to Xander. He loves his slaps. Oh, nice big boot as he pulls Jackson back right into it. And guys, I brought up Sushi X's Anarchy title reign a few moments ago, but let's take a second to talk about what happened at the top of the show here tonight as Sushi X came out to not only celebrate his championship win with the thousands and thousands of fans in attendance and the millions watching around the world. You know, it's a very emotional moment if you've been a longtime fan of Sushi's, a longtime viewer of CMV, but he said that wasn't what he was really out here to talk about tonight. He wanted to discuss the man, the coward, the Pousse, who brutally attacked Quantum just six nights ago on Monday Night Fusion. Of course, we know a mystery man, along with two others, disrupted Fusion, attacked Quantum, Hayden, and the world champion, Brian Novak. We learned that the man who attacked Novak in the main event, he was Justin Edwards, and the two others remained unnamed. The one who attacked Quantum, Sushi called him out. He wanted to see his face, know his name, give him a little bit of payback, and who would come out? Justin Edwards, the one man who we know for a fact. And Sushi X wasn't too happy, of course. That's not the man he wanted out here. And as Sushi X was looking at him dagger-eyed, it would be the rest of Webb. We know that that's their name now. Webb, they're calling themselves, would attack Sushi from behind. Brutally beat down by the trio before being launched at least 10 feet into the air. Came plummeting back down. Don't know the condition of Sushi just yet. I know that he's backstage currently getting checked on by the doctors, but we have now learned the other two men, the man who attacked Quantum, his name is Adam Bradley, while the man who attacked Hayden, his name is, actually no, I was wrong, the man who attacked Quantum is Jeff Wallace, the man who attacked Hayden is Adam Bradley. So we now know who they are. Justin Edwards, Adam Bradley, and Jeff Wallace calling themselves Webb, saying that CMV is theirs for the taking. Obviously putting a target on X-Gen right off the bat. The biggest names, Hayden, and the world champion, of course, Brian Novak. Ooh, nice reverse DDT there by Slate. Hopefully we get an update on Sushi X's condition. The new Anarchy champion can't be feeling too well. He wasn't even moving.
This match continues. We're looking at complete domination here.
And here's a tweet from, wait a minute, Slaywalk Slam by the CMV veteran as we get a tweet from Ryan Kent, who says, as you all know, I don't shy away from a challenge. That's why I'd like to announce that I have accepted Ann's stupid challenge. Oh, what a mistake he's made. Of course, getting to later on what happened between Christopher Ann and Ryan Kent before the show started here tonight as Morgan Jackson with that butterfly suplex into a bridge, looking to steal the win here. Oh, no, only a two count. But it seems like Ryan Kent has accepted the Southern Bells challenge for a rematch between the two after the Firestarter came off a victory against them last week on Genesis. Nice spine buster there. Vintage Slate. Well, a poll on the website asked what the CMV Universe thought of this new group, Webb, who disrupted Fusion this week, and a lot of people voted that they think they're cowards. Seven people voted that the group is nothing more than a bunch of pansies, while three people voted that they think they're going to be a vicious and well-calculated unit. So the CMV Universe doesn't seem to be too fond of this new trio. looking to make a name for themselves at the expense of the new Anarchy champion and his family and friends. Oh, wait a minute. Oh my God! Xander! Go on! What is he doing? Morgan Jackson propped up at the announce table! Elbow drop to the outside through the table! This is awesome! The fans chanting a player they right. What a move by Slate there. And he's not done. Hammering away. Christopher Ann is a Southern Belle. And now Xander is just picking apart the OG. So much so, yes, he collapses down onto one knee out of stamina. Might be looking for that count at victory. I don't know if Jackson's going to be able to get up. He's starting to stir. Count is 7 by the ref. Xander taunting like only he can. Jackson somehow back up into the ring. Right, oh my God, spear! Spear! Xander didn't see it coming. 1, 2. No, Xander kicks out. Morgan Jackson with a last-ditch effort. Final, like, shot of stamina takes him down with the spear, but Xander powers out. How did the OG have enough left in him to hit that? And now Jackson's in control. Xander still fighting, back to his feet, staggers the former international champion. Irish Whip is going to put Slate in the corner. And speaking of the international championship, the man who holds it currently, Chris Andrews, still don't know what is coming his way at Ascendance. Johnny Sampson's been quiet about what Chris Andrews is going to be doing with that championship in 4 weeks' time. We know that Jackson Jordan defeated the Bloody Brit 2 weeks ago on... Oh, no. Speaking of the Bloody Brit, flashback to homecoming here. Feet on the rope. Ref doesn't see it. Xander going to get screwed here. No, he powers out. Xander still going, not staying down, putting up a fight. What a match this has been thus far. What's up, Tazzy? Up top goes Slate now. Kick to the chest. Xander going to take another risk. Oh! Lunatic elbow drop is called or something. I don't know. Flying elbow through the air. Nonetheless, in a second, Slate walk slam. Shoots the half. 1, 2, 3, and Xander brings home the win. What a match and a much needed win for the CMB veteran, the dirtiest of heels. Slate bringing home the victory. One of only 3 men to ever pin Morgan Jackson now. And what a match. Ba-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Back and forth throughout. I thought it was over after that spear. Jackson, I think this is the first Slate walk slam. Yes, it was. Xander diving from the top of the top rope to the outside, elbow dropping the OG through the announce table. That was awesome. When you're in the waiting list, just believe you simply have to put your cause name and some tags would be nice. Tags so I can find them more easy. But yeah, that's all you gotta post and then you're done. I'll find them. You can look at the rules section if you want to. Just believe. It's located on the site. It's the top thread, I'm pretty sure. Click on that. You can check out the overalls. And as this match comes to an end, we get a tweet from Bloody Brit. He says, still the champ. Still waiting to find out who I'll be facing. Still putting on them 10 out of 10 matches. But for now, I'll be watching Genesis. Morgan will be on that 3-month losing streak now, thanks to me. Well, I guess we'll find out. Certainly tonight, Xander gets the win. Announce table in pieces here. Gonna have to get that rebuilt for the next match. Great win for Slate, though. Coming our way up next as the action continues. Ah. I thought the Azrael Headhunter match was next, but no. First, we've got Double J Jackson Jordan, of course, accompanied by Fusion and Genesis's general manager, Johnny Sampson, going toe-to-toe with the hypothetical kung fu practitioner, Kevin Lee, of course, accompanied by his blood brother, his best pal, Timmy Boy the Timster. First time we've actually seen Tim and Lee together since they lost their tag team title rematch some weeks ago. Afterwards, they kind of went their own paths for a moment, competing in singles action. Kevin Lee with a nice win over newcomer Dallas Chandler on a live event, but of course, as I've mentioned a couple times tonight, losing to Chris Andrews on Fusion, while Tim LaFave suffered that loss to Jackson Jordan last week on Genesis. Match of the week it was, though. So tonight we'll see if the man who can punch you in the back of the face will punch Jackson Jordan in the back of the face and get that W. Not yet, Maury. I haven't heard anything from Johnny Sampson. He's ringside here, though. Maybe he'll whisper something in my ear and I can let you guys know what's going on. Andrews, like he said himself, has been putting on some great matches. He lost to Jackson Jordan himself the top of the month, actually after Purgatory, I should say, in another amazing match. Almost got match of the week if it weren't for, what was the match that stole it from him? I don't remember. Or it did get match of the week, didn't it? I think it did. I'm not sure. I don't think so. I just don't remember what match did get match of the week. It was close, to say the, you know what I'm saying? No, I guess Azro versus Headhunter is after this one. I'm pretty sure I put it like that on the card, though. Maybe I mixed it up. Still coming tonight, though. Azro, Headhunter, third time this month. No holds barred, though, it will be. Will Azro get crushed, literally, for the third straight time, or will he pull off the upset and finally put down the Behemoth? Here he comes, the two-time and longest reigning international champion in CMB's history. That glove wrapped around the hand that's cracked many a jaw. And here's a tweet from Ryan Kent, very vocal tonight on the Twitter. He says, after I'm done beating the shite out of Ann, I'm going to hunt the group who calls themselves Webb into extinction. It's time for them to feel the pain they have caused Sushi. Hashtag revenge. Hashtag kings never die. Certainly couldn't have expected X-Gen to stay down. Like, they'd be like, oh, you know, they attacked Quantum and Sushi, but it's no thing. They gave Quantum, or I should say, Jeff Wallace gave Quantum a minor concussion. That's why he's not here tonight. Actually, I guess I could say it now. It's far off. Still months and months of CMB left on 2K16. But Season 3 and our reign on this game will end after Exodus. Season 4, 2K17 will begin afterwards, leading up to CyberSlam. Well, leading up to the second annual Tag Team Cup and then CyberSlam. But yeah, Season 3 will end after Exodus. Here they come, first time we've seen these guys enter together in a couple of weeks. And boy, does it feel right. They look so naked without the tag team titles of their champs for 5 months. Of course, reigning champs currently seemingly unstoppable. It's like the Fast and the Furious just stole all of T and Lee's unstoppability, just took it for their own. They're on quite a streak right now. Time to see if Kevin Lee can do what Tim could not last week, defeat Jackson Jordan. They wouldn't do that. I'm just praying to the almighty Lord, the Twitch gods, any god that wants to listen to me, that they just add freaking story designer back already. CMV would be a lot better. Or at the very least, I know Cop goes on about it, at the very least, bring back Universe mode from last year. We can get random cutscenes. The very least. 2K, the very, very least, at least bring that back. Ooh, nice Japanese arm drag. The fight already on the outside, 20 seconds in. Listen to his feet. Got that slow-mo action going on. We got Johnny Sampson and Tim LaFave watching ringside in support of their fellow bros. Nice sweep right there. Taking out the quad, tripping up Double J. They'll probably add in a couple of match types that they did this year. I'm expecting they bring back, like, Tornado, or not Tornado, the Tag Team Ladder, and probably I Quit or something like that. Backstage would be nice, too. That'd be cool. Back into the ring goes Kevin Lee. They wouldn't bring back all the entrances. They'd have to reanimate all of them. They're probably not going to do that. And Kevin Lee doing a cheeky little bit of taunting. Jackson Jordan ain't liking that. Yeah, but General Manager mode would be cool, but I wouldn't run CMV in that because you can't get any cutscenes at all unless they introduce cutscenes into a new General Manager mode. Now we get some back and forth arm drags. Reversal Fest 1999 up in her. Damn, arm drag central at the moment. Jeez Louise. Jeez Louise, man. Taking a step back, slicking that little hair that he has as he gets that snapmare. Not a snapmare, rolling neck snap, I should say. Kick to the knee, brings him down. Charging kick, two kicks to the chest. Oh, goes for an enziguri. Jackson ducks it, catches him the second time. That was a nice little spot. Kevin Lee says, fuck your shit. You're getting hit with this one way or the other. These vicious, absolutely devastating kicks of Kevin Lee's. Oh, now a drop kick to the temple. I buy 2008 General Manager was really fun, but I think 2007 had the best. I didn't like a lot of the roster too much in 2007, but if they took the GM mode from 07 and put it with the 08 roster, I might dig it. I think that would be good. The 08 roster was kind of lacking as well, but I think it was better than 07's. Timmy Boy backing up, showing respect to Double J here, as he did after the match on Twitter. Congratulated Jackson, said, let's do it again sometime. Doesn't want to risk a DQ, obviously, for his brother here. Up against the announce table. Smashed face first. Staggers the hypothetical kung fu practitioner. Cheeky jab. There's no hashtag, though. Dang, he is going in on Lee right now, though. Nice spinning kick around house to finish it off. I think 06's gameplay was fun. They had those like little mini games you could have as well, and the submissions worked a lot better. Like the ref would actually drop their arm. There was little cool things like that that they took out in 07. But so gameplay from 06, General Manager mode from 07, and roster from 08. And there you go. You got the perfect General Manager mode. Oh, going for his combination, I think. Jackson counters it, but then Kevin Lee's going to counter the counter into that snap power slam. One, two, just a two count. Couple of elbows right to the chest now. I thought Lee was looking for a corner cigar fin or something. I mean, cage matches, they improved on it from last year, at least. It seems like we've had a couple of really good cage matches this year, like Sunshine versus Levi Marta at CyberSlam, but they can be pretty bad. Last year, they were terrible, though. They went on for way too long. What was it, like a 50-minute match between Dave Turner and Paul Anderson the night after WrestleMania, or the first Ascendance, I should say. Please chill. Please chill. Seems like it went from too long to too short. Maybe next year they'll get it just right. As Kevin Lee goes for a pin, only a two count though. Legs wrapped around the throat of Double J here and a couple elbows. Gonna connect swiftly to the forehead. Jackson's rubbing at it. Snapmare. Superstars are as dominant as this guy. Yeah, they had that until 2011, Tim. They still had that feature in SVR 2011, so I remember doing it a lot. And they also had it where you could like bash their head off the steel steps and shit and ram their arm into the steel post. Combination by Kevin Lee, those slaps and punch to the chest and face. Still not enough to keep Jackson down, though. I've said it time and time again, they'll never add custom themes again because it's a licensing issue on the Xbox One now. There's actually no way to do it. It's not 2K's fault. Wait a minute. Roundhouse kick! Sends a couple of Jackson's teeth into the front row. One hit Johnny Sampson's glasses. Oh, wait a minute. What? Sampson? Sampson just ripped out the referee. Sampson has never interfered in Jackson's matches before, but 2.9999 Sampson pulls out the ref, and now Jackson looking for the hashtag. Wah-bah! Lays him out swiftly. Wait a minute, Tim! Tim never interferes in Kevin's matches. What is he doing? Tim LaFave! The biggest baby face you could ever make up, you could ever think of. Just interferes on behalf of Kevin, getting back at Sampson, I guess. These two guys legit never interfere in their guys' match. They both just did. They're desperate. Oh, double knees off the top now, slapping the knee, looking for a comeback. Clothesline one, clothesline two, goes for the clothesline, ducks it, does Lee in a nice super kick. Johnny just dusting off his jacket like it ain't no thing. Face of the year, yeah, it's Tim LaFave. There goes that combination again. Jackson ducks it once more, goes for a scoop slam, counter by Kevin. 1999 up in here though. Gonna go for the pin as Jordan, desperate. Right in front of Timmy Boy the Timster, looking Tim dead in the eyes. Only a two count though.
You have to wonder what's going through these guys' minds in a match of this magnitude.
If he gets going like this, no, he's not. Jacob Ziegler was awarded Breakout Star of the Year. Longest reigning Anarchy champion of all time. No more, though. Sushi X now. Still no update on Sushi X's condition, by the way. Haven't heard anything. As we get a nice boot to the head. Shout out to Sergeant Miller, former Sandy Tag Team Champion. Boot camp right there. Oh, a second one! What? Where'd he get that from? I thought Jackson countered his SIG. One, two, three! Kevin Lee just defeated, just pinned Jackson Jordan, ladies and gentlemen. And that streak was ended early. What a match. Both Johnny Sampson and Tim LaFave interfering on the part of their respective pals. But Kevin Lee with a second roundhouse literally out of nowhere. Don't know where he got that from. Gets him the win, a big win. Sampson said, well, I tried. You know, Johnny's trying to put on that persona. Like I said before, I love everything he's done thus far. Queen of the Ring, bringing in Conor McGregor, all that stuff. But I still don't trust him. If you've watched Unmatched Intensity, you can't trust him. You have no idea, Topher. You have no idea. Oh, wait a minute. Johnny's coming over my table, guys. Sampson not too happy about that loss for Jordan, but he's coming over my table. What's that? Okay. Oh, I feel you, Big Johnny. Oh, God. Shucky ducky. Quack, quack, ladies and gentlemen. I just got news from Johnny Sampson regarding Chris Andrews international title defense at Ascendance as he walks off to the back now, helping Jordan. Kevin Lee celebrates with Timmy Boy ringside. This is big news. I'll wait for Kevin Lee to stop celebrating as we get ready for the next match. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Sanders, the international champion, is going to be defending his international title in 4 weeks' time at Ascendance against Kevin Lee, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, I'm not done. And Jackson Jordan. Oh, but you think I'm finished? No. And Tim LaFave, ladies and gentlemen. A fatal four-way match going to go down on the grandest stage of them all for the international championship. Chris Andrews, Jackson Jordan, Kevin Lee, and Tim LaFave. Fatal four-way match for the international championship. What another blockbuster announcement by Johnny Sampson. That one is going to be good. That is going to be an amazing match, ladies and gentlemen. 4 weeks away, and I've just gotten word now, by the way. As he walked away, he let me know that next week on Monday Night Fusion, a big match to hype this up. It'll be Chris Andrews teaming with Jackson Jordan to take on Tien Lee in tag team action. That's next week on Monday Night Fusion. What an announcement, though. I cannot wait. Ascendance just gets better and better as we get closer and closer. But up next, Genesis continues. As we've got this no-holds-barred encounter between Azrael and Headhunter, the third time this month that these two will be going at it. X-Gen has always said in the past, they're brothers till the end. They'll never turn on each other. They've got each other's backs no matter what. But when they're in that ring together, if they're against each other, we've seen it in the past when Omega Z and Sushi have gone at it, or Quantum and Sushi, or any of them, Hayden and Sushi X, they look for that win. They respect it. They're going to put on a good match. So I'm sure Kevin Lee and Tim know that. I'm sure they'll work together. I wouldn't put it past them. But only one man can walk out as international champion. As here comes the Boa, he likes to call himself. Best of all time. I think that's what it stands for. I don't know. He's going to look at his jacket, but now he's got it off. Ah, here he comes. The 7-foot-tall, 400-pound behemoth, Headhunter. Looking to literally, for the third straight time, suffocate and squash Azrael. Azrael targeted Headhunter the first week of his career, trying to make a name for himself. Only one man has ever pinned Headhunter, and that came from Grid. So Azrael wanted to become the second man to ever do so. But Headhunter has not made it easy for him. Respectfully and honestly, the first time it was because Paul Heyman kept interfering. Azrael very well could have pinned Headhunter when he hit a super kick, but Heyman interfered. The second time, though, Heyman was disbarred from ringside. It was a clean one-on-one match, and Headhunter cleanly beat Azrael. But one more time, we're going to get it. No holds barred here. Anything goes. I don't know what Azrael was thinking accepting this match as Headhunter looks to get rid of his own personal nuisance before he teams up with Jamari Williams to help rid him of his personal nuisance in the form of extreme conditions at Ascendance. Headhunter laughing like a madman. You're gonna have to post those tweets again. I saw tweets by Rifted and Tim, but I missed them. I was doing my thing, please understand. We did get tweets, though, from both Kevin Lee and Tim LaFave, I'm sure, regarding that huge announcement. I missed them, though. My phone's got poor connection here, you know? Ringside. Fiddling with this wire, of course. Fiddling with it. Headhunter all over Azrael right out of the gate, not even letting the newcomer arise. Just keeps getting hammered back down. And out of the outside, no count out. Headhunter can have his way. Oh no, brings him back in the ring. Tossing him up over the top rope. There we go. Azrael's showing a little bit of life. Azrael, I heard someone say it before. Azrael certainly is one of the most fiery and tenacious newcomers we've had in a while. He did not want to wait around at the live events. He didn't want to work his way up. Had his first ever fusion match just 2 weeks into his career when he lost to Headhunter here. Oh, German suplex. You've seen it by Azrael. Can't be shocked at this point. He throws around Headhunter like it's fucking sack of dirty laundry. Headhunter like 100 sacks of dirty laundry put together. As we get a tweet from Eric Thunder, who says, wishing Azrael some luck for tonight and hoping he can do some damage to the monster to weaken him before our little battle at Ascendance. I don't know how little that battle is. Headhunter, 7'1", 400 pounds, no holds barred, being shown off, displayed here, as Azrael going ham on Headhunter's knee with the ladder, going for a super kick with the other leg. Certainly a good strategy by Azrael, work on the leg, keep the big man down. Scoop slam drops down behind his Headhunter. German suplex on the ladder. You can't really see, but I'm pretty sure it was on the ladder. I heard the noise. That's not good for the neck of the Boa. The Boa versus the Goliath here. He's the Goliath. There's no other. Here's that tweet from Kevin Lee that I missed before. He says, Tim, thanks for evening the odds tonight. One way or another, the international title is coming home with X-Gen at Ascendance. Big news. So Kevin Lee obviously excited coming off that win over Jackson Jordan, being announced as one of the three men who will challenge Chris Andrews for the international title at Ascendance. Fatal four-way match it will be. Nice little waistlock lariat there. Azrael dominating the big man right now. I mean, where's Dinkle? We got to get Dinkle up in here. Azrael taking a risk and it pays off. Elbow drop to all that back. He's loving it. I wonder if Azrael and... wait a minute! Uranic side slam. Headhunter tries to roll out of the ring but gets caught before he can. Hooks that tree trunk of a leg. Only a two count. I can't see the chat because it says it's lagging for me. Let me know if it actually is. We only have two official participants thus far out of 20, Maury, and that's Morgan Jackson and Xander Slate. The other 18 men yet to be revealed. I do not know. Headhunter grabbing Azrael by the head. Can't grab him by the hair. Got to pick him up by the neck like he's a puppy. Nice close-up there. That brutal snap power slam. What the fuck? Oh, I forgot he had this now. Last ride. That's a good 10 feet up into the air and drop down hard. I'm surprised Azrael didn't go through the goddamn canvas, but somehow he has enough in him to power out. Jesus, now a hero slam, Headhunter. He's a big man. Big men aren't especially known for having a whole lot of stamina. Trying to regain some here, put some gas back in the tank. Azrael, meanwhile, trying to get back to his feet in time. To no avail, though, up against the ropes! Back body dropped out onto the apron. Shatters that jaw, Headhunter lying in wait. What is he going for here? Yardage of his own! I mean, Maury, Buzzsaw Jax is a sit-out, last drive, powerbomb. Get it right? Jeez. Oh, God, what does Headhunter have in store here? Tree of Woe. I would prefer this for Azrael. I thought he was going for the fucking... the big booty sniff maneuver in the corner again. Rump Shaker? I don't know what it's called. I forgot. Here we get a tweet from Bloody Brit. He says, breaking news regarding my international championship. Not one, not two, but three opponents for me. But how did I become number one contender? That's right, I won a fatal four-way. So at Ascendance, it's going to be war. But next week, me and JJ versus T and Lee will have a hashtag and some revenge for you guys. Bloody Brit, not seeming fazed, not backing down from the massive challenge coming his way. He won't even have to be pinned to lose his title at Ascendance, but as he said himself, he's won a four-way in the past, became number one contender by winning a four-way. So he ain't fazed, and talking to smack to T and Lee there, as we now know that next week on Fusion, it will be Chris Andrews and JJ versus T and Lee tag action, as Azrael is just toying, or I should say, Azrael's being toyed with by Azrael. Oh my God, I'm stupid. Azrael is being toyed with by Headhunter. Jesus. Oh. That sell by Headhunter, though. That was good. That was a good sell. GG. Azrael, if I were him, I'd just lay down at this point. He is getting absolutely mauled. Headhunter loves to play with his dinner. Ascendance is 4 weeks away after tonight. The four solid weeks left of the grandest stage of them all, the fourth annual Ascendance. Oh, taking out a metal bat. We saw that used earlier. Oh, no, Azrael changed his mind. Said, nah, I just wanted to look at it for a second. Hello. Azrael keeps on fighting. That's one of the greatest characteristics of this young man. Oh, I think he might have gone for. Oh, I think Headhunter might have gone for his big splash. He had some trouble there. I wasn't sure, but I think he did. Azrael, if he did indeed counter the big splash, huge opening he just created. Can he capitalize on it? Pullback attack! Samoan drop onto the metal bat. Azrael scratching and clawing at that lower part of his spine. Or the sheer Nui. When you do a groggy one. Oh, no. Oh, God, no. Azrael, move. Azrael, please move. I want to attempt to go save him. Oh, man. One, two, three. Azrael, for the third time straight, gets squashed as we get a nice close-up of that back fat. Azrael, please let this be done. Please let this be done, Azrael. You cannot beat Headhunter. I give him props. A round of applause. I'm not actually going to clap, but a round of applause in my mind. A silent round of applause for Azrael for trying as he might. But Jesus. All 400 pounds of Headhunter splatting Azrael all over the canvas. And I'm actually getting word right now, ladies and gentlemen, that Azrael is the third official man confirmed for the Ascendance Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. That is, if you can make it there, 4 weeks is enough time to recover from that. Might have a collapsed fucking lung as Azrael simply sits on his opponent to get the three count. Who set up that ladder, though? But if Azrael is well enough in time for Ascendance, he will be participating in the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. Certainly, what is next for Headhunter? We know that he's got that tag match alongside Jamari, taking on extreme conditions at Ascendance. But after that, I mean, Johnny Sampson's got to be considering this man for a title shot. He's definitely earned it. One loss in his entire career, and currently he's on a winning streak. I certainly am not jealous of whoever Sampson decides to sick him after, if he does. If only. But up next, we got some tag team action coming our way. I don't know. Are you in this universe? I've never seen your name before, bud. So I couldn't tell you. But we do know that in 4 weeks' time at the Show of Shows, well, we see brother versus brother as Elijah Stewart collides with DJ Moore, former World Tag Team Champion, is going to go at it after DJ Moore revealed to the world that it was Elijah Stewart behind his brutal assault some months ago that put him on the shelf with a torn quad and dislocated shoulder. And we know that DJ Moore is not at 100%. He came back way too early, and we saw him show the effects of that at a live event earlier this week. He did get the win over, who'd he beat? My memory is so shit. I don't know. DJ beat someone. I think it was a newcomer. I'm not too sure. He defeated someone, but whoever fought him viciously and relentlessly targeted that torn quad. And DJ, after the event, went to the doctors, and they said he should have taken a lot more time off. He should still take some time off, at least take the next 4 weeks before competing on a set. DJ said, no how, no way. I'm going to get through everybody on my path to destroy my brother and finally put the final nail in his coffin. Finally, put the nail in his coffin and put an end to their family once and for all. But tonight they tasked each other with finding some partners to shackle up with and go at it. Elijah Stewart choosing the newcomer Bob Luger, of course, accompanied by his legendary father, Lex Luger. Bob, the only second-generation superstar in CMV currently, not in history. We have Lex, the son of Sheik, before, and Shinaz Andoni is the nephew of Iron Sheik, but the former two-time light heavyweight champion and longest reigning world tag team champion, Andoni, a former rival of DJ's, is his pick for tonight. Two former tag champs coming together. And here's a tweet from Nick Blake that says, Nick Blake sits comfortably in Nick Blake's home watching Genesis, knowing that brother fucker William Weaver can't touch Nick Blake. How does it feel to be leashed like a dog, Billy? Lex Luger apparently coming out with Elijah here. Bob Luger's still getting dressed, so Lex is coming out here with Elijah, backing him up. God, I love that attire. Elijah Stewart one-on-one with DJ Moore at Ascendance. And there was a tweet there from Elijah earlier. I don't remember what it said exactly. Something like, don't call me a coward. Don't call me a liar. I'm just opportunistic. Stewart saying that Moore made him this way. He turned him into what he is by trying to make Stewart more aggressive. We all know Stewart was the fun-loving, energetic guy who would never be down, always trying to get everybody else up. Says that DJ trying to make them more aggressive changed him. And he thinks it's for the better. DJ was right, but Moore, he never wanted this. Here comes Luger. Now, he wasn't getting dressed backstage. He was still running on his treadmill. He was still wrapping up his workout. There you see Elijah Stewart choosing Bob Luger as his partner tonight. And this man, the real number one Bubba, the Punjabi playboy, Johnny Gap. One half of the longest reigning world tag team champions in CMB's history. Alongside Chet Taylor and hashtag trending worldwide, rest in peace. The former two-time light heavyweight champion just lost his belt recently at Purgatory. It's the first time we've seen Shinaz since then, as he is chosen by a former rival of his, DJ Moore. Two tag champs, separate partners, shackling up. It's going to be something to see. But Billy Weaver retweeting Nick Blake here saying, who's William? Nick Blake, certainly probably not super excited that he has to be locked inside of a steel cage at Ascendance against Billy, but for the next 4 weeks, as he said himself, he gets to rest easy, because if Weaver so much as spits in his direction, then the match will be called off and Billy will be sent back to jail. Water! Oh yeah. Listen, you know his nickname might be Dashing, his first name might be Dennis, but there is no relation, I promise you. I mean, we're hardly friends. You know, we're acquaintances at best. Here he comes, though. DJ Moore with two wins under his belt since returning. Looking to get some momentum over his brother. Lay his hands on Elijah. And it's going to be Elijah Stewart and Shinaz Andoni kicking things off. These two know each other. They fought one-on-one in the past. Oh, nice drop kick there. Damn, some velocity sent Shinaz flying. Yeah, that cheeky smirk by DJ. He knows. He knows what's good.
So that's what it's like being so far off the mark. He's doing everything he can to get his bearings back here. This match could be over sooner than anyone could have anticipated.
Yeah, Cole, this is when you... And I saw someone say it earlier, but I can confirm now officially that Shinaz Andoni has been announced as another participant, the fourth man made official for the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal in 4 weeks' time at Ascendance. So that's some big news there. Four big names so far set. Morgan Jackson, Xander Slate, Azrael, now Shinaz Andoni added to the mix as we remember the life and times of Slick B, the greatest. They die so young. Shinaz Andoni with a headbutt right to the fucking lip, trying to kiss him. Who said it? It was Topher or whoever said it. That's going to be a light. The spotlight is going to be representing Slick B. He's coming down from the heavens. He can't miss Ascendance. What a great weekend of WWE action. Airplane spin now to Bob Luger. Bob Luger, another man who has gone one-on-one with Andoni. Luger actually pinned Shinaz when he was the light heavyweight champion still. It was a couple weeks ago, Monday Night Fusion.
Oh, look at this.
Luger was getting tired of people not taking him seriously, beating him up backstage, stealing his matches on Fusion. So he called in the big guns, his legendary father, Lex, and Lex saying that he's going to make Bob Luger great. Saying that his son's not going to be taken as a joke anymore. He's going to be taken seriously. As DJ ties up the legs for this Romero special here, doing some damage. It's his mixtape. Didn't we agree that the winner will get his mixtape, his unfinished mixtape? No, but the winner will get a load of momentum for sure. Defeating 19 other men on the grandest stage of them all could get you a possible title shot. Nice counter there by Luger, and then a nice backbreaker to follow it up.
He gets the tag, and he might have to do this by himself. His partner doesn't have much left.
Oh, here we go. Elijah Stewart and DJ Moore laying hands on each other. And Stewart just making his brother smell his armpit first. Right back to the front headlock. Drags him off. Hurricane Rana. It's hardly able to get him down, but he did. He pulled through. He persevered. Oh, Neon. I cannot wait for that. Big Neon makes his return. Tag to the real number one, Bubba. Maybe DJ is not ready just yet to confront his brother one-on-one, face-to-face. Relentlessly stomping on the quads. Shinaz, boot to the jaw. Blinds Elijah for a moment.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
Ooh, nice neck breaker there, swinging around a little bit. Some pizzazz. The show off, the showstopper. Andoni's gonna steal your girl. I wouldn't be surprised. I mean, look at them. Look at that bow tie. I don't know how a lady could look at that and not instantly get wet, to be honest. As Shinaz gets tossed in the corner, Elijah. I wouldn't say those are light colors on Elijah. It's black with a little bit of white. I'd say silver, really. Oh! Somersault cutter a second rope there.
I think we're about to see a high-risk move from the top rope.
I think you're right, Cole.
Oh, perfect position. What's Andoni got in store here? Body splash. Shanaz's not a big man. That's still going to hurt you. Oh, and that enziguri of his.
Awesome move by Tony.
Tony the Tiger. Shannon Tony. It looks like Lex Luger's distracting the ref here. Yes, he is. Shanaz going to have to let go of the pin. We saw Lex interfere a couple times in his son's match last week on Genesis. And now calling for Andoni's attention. Elias going to take advantage. Pump handle suplex. Back suplex there. Tag to Luger.
And now he's back out on the apron.
Relentlessly beating on the down. Shanaz, Irish whip to the corner.
Each time we broadcast on a Saturday, I can't help but think of the famous...
Oh, what do we got? I think it says Tower of London inbound. Yes, it is. Luger ain't even from London. Has Luger even ever been to London? Are he and Nick Blake good friends? I don't know. To the top rope. The newcomer looking to take a risk. Perfect position. What's got set up? Leg drop. Executed to perfection. Flips him over.
He's pulling out all the stops tonight. Nobody home there. Nobody home. Oh, that looked like the house had been
The thing you guys don't understand is that everybody you've announced is going to be in that battle royale. It's going to be everybody returning for one night only. And the four guys who have already been announced. Morgan Jackson, Xander Slay, Azrael, Shanaz Andoni, and everybody that you've all just predicted. Irish whip, gonna be Grandma from season one of CMB. You know, Alex Jade, you know.
You know, there's just so much at stake for these
Spine buster, and then raining down a flurry of punches. DJ wants to unleash his anger on poor Luger here. Bloodline! Looking to finish things here, right in front of his father. One, two, dusting off that wife beater. Getting off them Dorito crumbs.
That was rough.
What a shot to the temple, then a kick to the spine. And Moore ain't playing around, wasting a little time. As we're going to get that less is more. Brutal neck breaker down onto the shoulder. Looking to finish things, but Elijah, we know how fast he is. Too quick. What? Oh, don't tell me this got glitched. God damn it. No. Let's see if he can break it up, though. Maybe he can break it up. No. One, two, three. Oh, it's over. Ding, ding, ding. Oh, what a finish. DJ got the pin via telekinesis. As Elijah and Shanaz beat the shit out of each other ringside. Oh, what a match. What a finish. That was great. Oh, my God. What a win for DJ Moore. Oh. I don't really want to restart that. I'll restart it if you guys want me to. If not, I don't know. We'll figure out. I don't know. We'll say DJ. I think that would have been a three count if Elijah hadn't broken it up. I think Lex interfered as the pin was happening. I'm not sure what happened. They pulled his leg up with him. He just wasn't having it. All right, yeah, we'll restart. We'll say it just keeps going on.
Ladies and gentlemen,
oh, but it's gonna okay play end. Really? I've never seen it play entrances again. It's that shit. Why did it do entrances again? That shit was dumb. Here we go. This match continues. Ignore that second bell. Didn't hear it. You didn't hear it. You're hearing things. You're going crazy, guys. You're going crazy. DJ Moore tagged out to Shanaz, and Elijah got the tag out. Or I should say Bob Luger got the tag out. Saved himself. Elijah's in now.
It'll be interesting to see who becomes the alpha male.
Oh my God, these knife edge chops across the goddamn face.
Dominance.
Lighting it up. Man, Northern Lights.
I like the pairing model. These two work so well together as a team. Oh, out of nowhere.
Certainly these two teams have worked very well together. I'm surprised about Shanaz and DJ. It was a long, long time ago that they, you know, went at it over the tag team titles, but still, it was the family, you know, DJ and Elijah, who ended hashtag Shredding Worldwide's legendary reign way back when Anarchy Rules.
Each of these competitors is looking for the slightest hit of weakness in the other.
Well, that's a strategy you have to always have in the back of your head, Cole.
Tagged to Bob Luger.
You gotta jump on it.
I mean, you know, Kent just had to get that grand slam, you know. That's Kent's thing this season. He wins a title just to add it to his resume and then loses it. Did it with the international title as well. Just really needed that grand slam, you know. That's just Ryan Kent's gimmick this year. Another backbreaker by Luger. I'd say it's Luger perfect. That was a strange movement. There was a kid who used to go to my school named Moomin. Yes, that was his name. Everybody actually called him Moo Moo. Is that you, Borton? Is that you? Have I gone to school with you? Did I go to high school with you, Borton? Don't lie. I know.
It won't take long for the aggression to escalate quickly in this one. You're right, Cole.
Shanaz lifting Luger to his feet. Looking to get some revenge for that loss a couple weeks back. Shanaz just constantly burying DJ's finisher in this match. Second variation of a neck breaker thus far. Ooh. Stomped down onto the quad and that injured quad of Moore's. Borton, my awesome mooing friend. Oh my god! I guess Lex really has been working with Bobby to bring up his strength, making him great. Oh, and right to that quad, Elijah knows. Gonna soften it up even further as we get closer to a sentence in their one-on-one match. Oh, but DJ's had enough. And attack to Shanaz, gotta rest that leg, man. If DJ were smart, he really would take the 4 weeks off before Ascendance, but he's just not having it. He doesn't want to show weakness towards his brother. Oh, and Enzo Gurry, poor Luger knew the SIG was coming. Had to tag out. One, two, just a two count. Bobby trying to get the fans behind his team. I don't think the fans are going to much go for them, though. Arm drag. Elijah looking for the tag out now. Going to save himself. Make Luger take the fin as Luger made him take the SIG. Oh, there's Lex. The most tanned man I've ever seen in my life. Heel kick. Rest in peace, but the ref distracted at the hands of Lex for the second time in this match. And now there's a steel chair just ominously lying in wait. The ref hasn't seen it yet somehow, even though he's standing on it a couple of seconds ago. And now Luger's got a second chance. Going for that backbreaker again. Oh no, we haven't seen it. I don't think we've ever seen him hit this. Luger, perfect elbow drops. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And here comes the 10th one. Flicks the sweat from his hair down to the face of Shanaz, showing no respect as he now hooks the leg. 1, 2, just a two count. Now trying to crank that neck, and Doni's fighting, though the fans are rallying, getting to their feet. Could we possibly see him Shanaz up? Just a two count. Is it? I know. I think you might have just saw that it's free for a couple of days right now if you have gold. They do like a look at the basketball thing they always do. It's free for like 4 days or something right now. So, hey, Dynamic, you could download it real quick, make Kent, and then just then bam, you're done. You make your own Kent. I think it's still free for a couple of days, so There's a German suplex by DJ out of the corner.
You know, there's just so much at stake for these teams in this match. And winning this one would be
going for the pin is more.
Well, as you can see,
one. Just a one count.
Like they say, Cole, timing is everything.
Yeah, I don't think it's a game with gold. It's just free for a couple of days. I thought he was shooting for the leg instead because of a wrestling clown showing off his background. Tag to Elijah, brother to brother once again. Where's Stewart taking DJ now? Thought he was going to go for a suicide dive or something. Not taking that risk, though. Stiff forearm off the rebound. DJ going for a pin after every single move he hits, every single opening he gets, shoots for it. Got to preserve that quad, man. You're going to have to buy golf again. I never pictured you as a golfer, Dynamic, to be honest. Oh, Bloodline! For a second time to his own brother. Luger, once more key at ringside for helping out his son and his partner tonight. But Shanaz helping out DJ a little bit. The ref's scared of Lex and his beautiful tan. Doesn't want to eject him. On Moore looking for another. Less is more. Looking to break his brother's neck. Snap it into pieces. One, two, come on, Shanaz. He took the long way around, and that costed him. Wasn't even Lex disrupting the bout this time. Shanaz is just at a momentary lapse. Memory there. As DJ letting out his frustrations, beating Elijah's face in. I mean, just wait for State of Decay 2, Batman. State of Decay 1 was amazing, and State of Decay 2, they're adding multiplayer. I mean, just wait for that. Oh, I like how the sound effect matched up perfectly with Lex messing with the steel steps on the outside. Luger's pissed off that his own son's shackling with this mistake right now. Where the hell is Andoni going? To the top. Oh, but okay. GG. I mean, the games I want to get are Skyrim Remastered, State of Decay 2, obviously, and Friday the 13th. Those are the games I'm going to get. Friday the 13th looks bomb as hell. Tagging to Luger now. See if he can pick off Shanaz. Going for that Lugerplex, but Andoni ain't having it. The force field's activated. Hits him with the reverse STO. Now for the pin. One, two, just a two count. I mean, State of Decay's story mode isn't garb.
Neither of these teams appear to be showing any quit here tonight.
Going ham with that elbow right to the temple.
These two teams are true.
Those tassels on Shanaz's boots. Rubbing in his face. And Zaguri, this pin happened right in front of Elijah, though. Oh, wait a minute, DJ! Okay. He tried to give his own brother a surprise blowjob, I think. I'm not too sure. Careful, Lex, with your blue jeans. Relax. European uppercut going to stagger Andoni. Exchanging gut kicks. Luger needs to make that tag. Elijah. What the? What? All right. Showing off that strength again. The show off. Bob Luger now looking for that Lugerplex. Ties up the arms. Tosses him like a sack of dirty laundry. But he can't make it to the pin. He's going to be late. Can he still get the 1-2-3? Of course, he's going to take even more time as he doesn't want to risk a rope break. Lateral press. If Elijah can stop DJ, this one's going to be over. And he can. Three, Bob Luger once more pinning Shanaz, gets he and Elijah the win as Stewart gets a leg drop bulldog and more to prevent him from making the save. I I've got Gears of War 4 pre-ordered, thanks to Pop. So that's going to be delivered to me day of. Oh, undefeated since his dad came to join him and started interfering in his matches, yeah. But Elijah Stewart finding himself a good partner, I guess, as Blue Jean Sick Tan ringside. Gonna bring them to a win. Wasn't good for DJ's injury either. If I were Johnny Sampson, I'd just force DJ Moore to take some time off. Don't want to risk a lawsuit. Pull a CM Punk as DJ. It's probably, Gears of War 4 is probably one of the most beautiful looking games I've ever seen. I don't play a lot of great graphical games though. And the beta was pretty fun, multiplayer. Plus I'm getting it for free, so I'm not going to complain. There's the finish though, you saw Luger get the 3 count following the Lugerplex. Elijah stops DJ from making the save. And a nice win for these two. It was pretty cringeworthy. I watched that, Tim. And a nice little shot there. Lex in the middle. That tan, though. It can't be healthy to be that tan. Bobby, you got to talk to your dad, man. And now it is co-main event and Vixen's time for Genesis Edition number 44, as we get a rematch from 2 weeks ago, which saw the Urban Warrior Fury take on America's Sweetheart Jade Devine. It was an amazing match. Ended with some controversy, though, after Jade got a rope break, but the ref didn't see it. Counted the three following a stunner from Fury, so both of them agreed to a rematch, showed high respects to each other. And now they go one-on-one tonight, hoping for a clear and decisive winner, as Fury gets prepared for her first round Queen of the Ring tournament match in 2 weeks' time. And, of course, Jade Devine, America's Sweetheart, the cheeky Japanese girl, the first ever Vixen's Mini Royal Rumble winner, earning her spot in the co-main event of Ascendance, where she will challenge Kitty Quinn Bell, the Queen of Botchville, for the Vixen's title, as my dogs are fighting in the background. They're excited about this one. Of course, still to come, our main event after this one. Certainly not going to want to miss it. Randy Orton, the Moo Moo Man, looking to have Mookamania run wild all over the unpredictable Just Insane, as both those men have some monumental bouts coming their way at Ascendance. And I actually heard word that Orton, very rarely he does this, debuting a new attire tonight. So I think he's only had two different attires in his entire three-year CMB career. So that'll be something to witness. Fury, two-time Vixen's champion, was just a few weeks off from breaking Amber Briggs' longest reign as champ, but that was ended by Kitty Quinn Bell inside a Hell in a Cell at Purgatory. Ralph, can you simmer down? Why do you keep barking at Sugar? Such a bully. Sugar even, like, almost come near him in his general vicinity of 5 feet. He just absolutely mauls her. Fury will be going one-on-one with Cass LaFave in their first round matchup in the Queen of the Ring tournament 2 weeks away. We already know that Cassie Maverick defeating Big Bad Briggs 6 minutes ago on Fusion has advanced to the first semifinal matchup. Could very well at Ascendance. It'd be awesome to see Cassie Maverick one-on-one with Fury, two of the undoubtedly greatest vixens in CMB history, competing to crown the first ever Queen of the Ring. The WWE Universe, the CMB Universe, is always pumped up when Jay Devine makes her way down to the ring. The cheeky Japanese girl with the opportunity of a lifetime to co-main event the grandest stage of them all, a card that is absolutely stacked already. And we're still 4 weeks away. There's still so much to be announced, I'm sure. Winning the annual Vixens Mini Battle Royal at Absolution, eliminating all five of her opponents to earn a shot at Quinn Bell in the Vixens title. This is going to be a good one. Fury one-on-one with Jay Devine. They're going to make up for that screw job, that iffy ending a couple of weeks back. And even though Jay Devine suffered a loss because of the ref being blind, still showed high respects to Fury after the match with a tweet saying it was a great match, and despite the, you know, hiccup, she'd like to do it again sometime. And Fury, surprisingly, very rarely does she do this herself, showed respect back towards Jade, in fact saying Jade's the only vixen on the roster that she respects. So the two agreed to a rematch here. Both of them need the momentum. Jay Devine probably more so than Fury, as Devine's been on a little bit of a losing streak since Purgatory. Nice little leapfrog back and forth to start off this one. Fury hip toss, though, countering Jade's. Quinn Bell, though, coming off her own sour loss to the hands of Morgan Black. That was quite an upset on last week's Genesis. So Jade could turn the totem pole for momentum wise. Oh, big time power bomb. She lifts her up. And here's a tweet from Parker. I don't know, Parker could actually form sentences. Every time he used to tweet in the past, I just thought it was his sister doing it. Maybe it's just Hannibal doing it for him here. But anyway, the tweet says, "Waiting on my spot for the tag tournament battle royal, and now I want a challenge answered. Headhunter, I want another shot next week." I don't know if Parker... I'm not too sure if Parker still thinks that the Tornado Tag Team title tournament is still going on. He's talking about the turmoil match, and he wants the battle royal, and again calling out Headhunter. Last time those two fought months ago, Hunter squashed Parker, put him for the announce table and all. Oh, choke slam by Fury to Jade here. But Parker does have a chance alongside his partner Hannibal. Doom will be going against the Bromancers next week on Monday Night Fusion in a qualifying match to see who will meet the Briggs family, the Fast and the Furious, and the Republic. Take that fourth spot, so two to be revealed afterwards. Two to be taken. I don't know when you left, Rifted, so this is the co-main event right now. Fury one-on-one with Devine. Ooh, nice wrestling slam. Woo! That knife edge chop. Lighten up that face a little bit. She comes from behind. Fury ain't have that. Doesn't like you taken from behind. Hope lovely Lewis has taken note of that. As we get a Northern Light suplex. And up to the top, she can't have a Divine Arrow, but she's going for something. Taking a risk. Oh, shooting star. Dang, she was a little bit overzealous there, a little bit ahead of herself. Might backfire, knocking herself out. No, only a two count. Close, though. They're going to take advantage of the opening. You are pretty late, Tom Kappa. Hello. A wrist lock suplex there now. Jade hooks the leg, just a two count. Oh, then Headhunter defeated Azrael once again by sitting on him. And then Elijah Stewart and Bob Luger defeated the team of Shinaz Andoni and DJ Moore. So that's what you missed. That would be good. Maybe Parker can make it into the fourth annual King of the Ring when it comes our way. As this match continues, Fury put in the corner, Divine. Oh, Divine! The fans know very well what could be coming next here. That spider suplex closely following that comes the Divine Arrow. Fury gonna be in trouble here. No, what? Wait a minute, what? Oh, Fury with a kip up. Divine kind of got like shocked at like, wait a minute, what? She tried to go for a finisher. Fury looking for a comeback, clothesline, ducks Jade's attempt at one, back body drop now, and a spinebuster inbound. Oh, hit with such force. Oh, look at this stunner! That's the move that beat Jade on Fusion. A couple of middle fingers flung her way into the pin. One, two, only a two count though. Fury with her hands on her head. Cannot believe that did not finish the cheeky Japanese girl. High angle Vag Lab slam. Vag Lab. That Vag Grab slam. Michinoku driver, a.k.a. Look at those overhand shots thrown wildly. I saw Albius's post. I super hope they bring Corey Graves up. But I know that they're probably just going to put Byron Saxton on SmackDown. Probably what's going to happen. Divine. A second chance here. Divine Arrow inbound. Can she get it this time? She goes for it. There it is. No. Fury moved out of the way and playing possum. And we get a nice replay of the miss. The hit and miss. And Fury backing up into the corner. Doing a little bit of moonwalking. Another Michinoku driver. Byron is on SmackDown? I thought it was that Mauro Ranallo guy and the white dude. Todd something. And then King. We have the best job in the world. I wouldn't mind Otunga on SmackDown. I like Otunga. I don't watch SmackDown, so I don't even care. But oh, Borton just in time. Well, almost just in time. This is the co-main event here. Very back and forth. Great match thus far. It ain't over yet. Jay Divine missing the Divine Arrow, but Fury Knight able to capitalize afterwards. Slaps that ass. German off the top. Into the pin. Shoots the half. One, two, but again, only a two count. Gonna keep up the pressure. Fury back in the corner looking for the combination again. Urban Warrior ain't having the baddest bitch on Fusion and Genesis. Just put right back there though, up top. I don't know if she has enough stamina. Nope, gonna slap that ass again. Corner to corner with these German suplexes. Not going for the pin this time. Realizes she's gonna need something a little bit more oomph to get the 1-2-3, the uno, dos, tres. Oh, that always tricks me. I always think they're actually going for roll-up schoolboys, but instead with a power bomb. That strength, always a dangerous asset of Fury's. Ties up the legs, Indian deathlock. Puts pressure on that knee. Jay gonna break out of it though with a quick, swift punch right to the face. Now a spine buster. Oh, Jade not wanting to risk going for a Divine Arrow again. Looking for a bangarang perhaps. Rarely, very rarely does she pull this out. Looking to get the win though. One, two, no! Fury still kicking out. Jesus. I think Otunga is one of their lawyers now. I think that's why he's not been released. I heard it somewhere. I think I read it one time. I'm not sure if it's true, but I think he's one of their lawyers. Why he's not released.
This one's not over yet. We've seen
in the driver's seat, Jade trying to keep up the pain, not give Fury a second to breathe, because she knows if she does, she's going to live to regret it. Spread. Whoa! Whoa! Spear! Spear by Fury catches Devon in the air! One, two, three! Oh my god! Spear! Catching Jay Devine mid-air brings this match to an end. Devine looking to take a risk and it backfired. The hell was that? My fucking cat somehow just got on top of the fridge. I don't know how. How the fuck did you get up there, Carter? Psycho. I think she cracked her neck on the rope. Hopefully we get that replay. Didn't look good for Devine. It was a little botched, I think. Jay Devine was in control, too. She just didn't try to take that risk, but that's what she is. She's a risk taker, a heartbreaker. Wants to put on a show for the fans. Looking to hit high impact to get the win. That was a bangarang. That didn't get her the three count, though. And here's the finish, a soccer ball kick to the spine. Devine goes out onto the ring apron. Fury lying in wait, playing possum, pulls out a spear. And you see Devine just hit, oh, right off the top rope. Her neck might be seriously injured there, guys. That did not look good, but Fury gets the win definitively this time. As Jay Devine suffers another loss, she and Quinn Bella just having a good time with these losses leading up to their Ascendance match. I usually say that, you know, Quinn Bella is probably a smile on her face, but her and Quinn Bella and Jay Devine, they're kind of their friends. They show respect to each other, so Quinn's probably worried about that. Wants Jay Devine at 100%, no doubt about it. Gonna have to wait to hear from the doctors about that one. The spear is a staple of CMV this year, this season. Fury's gonna be released after that botch. She just killed Jade. It's murder. Pulled a Rey Mysterio. Here we go, folks, though. It is main event time. Ralph is super excited. Someone home? I think someone might be home. Hello? Hello? Whoever it is, they're taking a good old time getting in here. But it is main event time, ladies and gentlemen. One-on-one rematch from last month. The Moo Moo Man, the Milkman, Randy Orton. Looking to have Milkmania run wild all over. The unpredictable one, just insane here tonight. Put on an absolute five-star classic last month. Hoping they can do it again, as both men have, without a doubt, the biggest matches in their respective careers. As Randy Orton alongside Kendall Wolf challenged Brian Novak for the undisputed title, a triple threat match in the main event, Orton's first ever Ascendance main event, the grandest stage of them all. I don't know how you couldn't have butterflies. And of course, just insane, we learned a dream match that I didn't even know I wanted to see. The CMB Universe didn't even know it wanted to see. Brett Angel arriving on Fusion 2 weeks ago, didn't say a single word, squared up Just Insane, got in his face, simply pointed at the Ascendant sign, and Just Insane nodded his head, and with not a single word spoken, we got one of the biggest matches to ever happen in CMB history. Brett Angel, an unmatched legend, two-time unmatched world champion, three-time world champion, I should say, goes toe-to-toe with Just Insane, a three-time undisputed champion, the longest reigning world champion. Perhaps the two men who could only rival each other clash. The show of shows. Truly a showcase of immortals, as indeed, as I said earlier, Orton showcasing a new attire tonight. It was a great attire. I'm loving it. Look at them TIE fighters. Nice milk carton on the back. We need to get a cutscene of Borton pulling a Kurt Angle, coming out here in the milk truck, spraying down Kendall Wolf and Novak with milk. That's going to be a promo. Borton, write it. And Randy Borton fell victim to Justin Sane the last time they collided. See if he can tie him up. Brett Angel's got to be watching wherever he is. I'm sure at home relaxing. But Justin Sane can't afford to take a loss in the eyes of Angel. God, that's going to be such a good match, guys. Do you understand this? Brett Angel, Justin Sane, one-on-one. Literally, I say it's one of the most, it's probably the most, the biggest match that we have ever seen in CMB's 4 years. This Ascendance card is absolutely stacked to the brim. It's golden. And ain't even done getting added to yet. I'll always spoil your milk, Borton. I spit in your milk. Borton, he has his own personal mini fridge backstage, and he keeps like 5 cartons of milk back there at all times. I always sneak in there, and I spit in a couple, and then I take one, and I give it to Tim. I say, "Hey Tim, I got you this nice milk jug, just for you. You know, out of my own pocket, paid for it." And he takes it. I go, "Thanks, Dashing." And then Borton comes like, "You steal my fucking milk again, Tim?" And Tim falls for it every time. Here we go, Randy Borton, beautiful new attire, one-on-one with Justin Sane, the second annual Cyber Invitational winner who lost his opportunity to main event his second straight Ascendance when he was beaten by Brian Novak at Purgatory with the title on the line. And Sane right out of the gate, backing Borton to the corner, takes the cheap shot. Sane is a dirty heel. There's never been any doubt about it. Sane does whatever he has to in a match to win, but the fans just love this guy. It doesn't matter if he was a bigger heel than Xander Slate. Everybody is always going to love Justin Sane.
Talk us through what Shang is thinking right now.
Definitely looking confident in this one-on-one environment. That's a good sign.
Borton grabbing the Arn Anderson of Justin Sane here. Confirmed Arn Anderson in the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. Great observation, Tomcat. That attire is yellow. I can confirm. I guess if someone's colorblind, I'm not sure if we have any colorblind viewers, but it is yellow. It is yellow attire. Borton, oh my God, trying to back up into the corner for safety. And Sane, I think, just broke his neck, joining Jay Devine. Double burial, rest in peace, Jesus. Fucking Sane. This ain't about it. Irish whip, Sane off the ropes. Borton lying in wait, goes for a belly to belly, perhaps. We're not going to find out. Justin shuts it down with a leg sweep. The main event of Genesis, and what a show it has been. So many huge announcements. A Fatal 4-Way match made official for the international title. Chris Andrews going to defend against Jackson Jordan, Kevin Lee, and Tim LaFave at Ascendance. Of course, you know Billy Weaver will go one-on-one with Nick Blick inside of a steel cage. Multiple names added to the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. It's been quite a night with some great matches to boot. Going to finish it off as these two go at it. Whatever happened to fucking, what was his name? Andy Savage. Whatever happened to Andy Savage? Nacho Man? Gotta bring him back. Confirmed for the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal, without a doubt. Gotta get him back in here. Ascendance is 4 weeks away, so I don't know exactly which day it's gonna be on. 4 weeks. Unless I stream more than twice 1 week or something, I don't know.
Too fast.
Oh, oh, nice. That face buster. They're kicking back legs from extra oomph. Haven't seen that hit in a while. Zach Cage constantly tries to go for it, but always gets it reversed. Just insane ain't no Zach Cage, though. Confirmed, Andy Savage, the Nacho Man, added as a fourth. We're going to have two fatal four-way set ascendants. Borton going to the top. Former two-time undisputed champion, Money in the Bank winner, with a nice HBK-esque elbow drop. We know HBK is Borton's hero, his role model.
Few superstars are his direct counter.
Oh, jumping cutter by Sane out of nowhere. One, two, Borton ain't done for just yet, though. Milkamania keeps running strong as the Milkamaniacs in attendance here tonight all around the world are looking for the Moo Moo Man to become a three-time world champion. Take down the 2018 CMB Royal Rumble winner Kendall Wolfen. The champ himself, Brian Novak, is saying I think might have gone for a catapult fin there. Borton ain't having that one, a hell of a Luthez, and then raining down some shots. Pinfall attempt, will it be enough? Close. That was close.
Well, that's just not enough to get the job done.
It's only been one cutter this far. I'm sure it's not the last one we'll see, though. So many were shocked, left on their at. Oh, wait a minute. Vintage Borton with that follow-away slam. Haven't seen him go for that in a while. Usually tries to pull out the Moo Thunder Bomb these past couple of months, but so many were left in utter shock. Myself included, my jaw. Whoa! Whoa! Single leg highly out of nowhere by Sane. One, two. Oh, damn. That was almost a three. Is that a new finisher by Sane? I haven't seen him go for that before. But as I was saying, the CMB Universe left in dismay when Sane actually lost to Brian Novak at Purgatory. I don't think anybody voted for Brian Novak to defeat the unpredictable one, but Novak, as he has come accustomed to doing these past couple of months, proving all the doubters wrong, all the haters wrong, and now he's going to be main eventing the grandest stage of them all as you get a nice Shiranui here by Sane. Slim B is Slick B's brother. You know? Oh, nice STO. I was actually hoping to get Slick B's brother on commentary at Ascendance for the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. So we'll have Slim B on commentary. Hopefully goes for it again. Borton dodged it this time, though. If I would have remembered Jen's finisher name for Chet Taylor, I would have said it. I don't remember it, though. Something. Ah, winning the internet it is. Justin Sane tried to win the internet, but he failed. Sane ain't no hipster. Far from it. Nice combination there. Needed a temple and a neckbreaker, though. Borton in trouble nonetheless. Sends a nice little sweet kiss, mwah, to Borton as he gets a nice swanton from the second rope.
In the back to see which one of these guys comes out victorious. Not every move is designed to get the fans off their feet.
Ooh, nice side headlock there. Middle of the ring. The Moo Man's got to figure out a way to rally the fans. Turn this around. Keeps going the way that it is. You're going to see Sane with his hand raised once again. Snapmare takes down Sane. Side headlock of his own now. Justin's got no plans of sticking around. Back to his feet. Oh, the need to win. Another knee. Looking to further smash that face in. Oh, and the three count. Justin Sane had that need to win. With a dominant victory over Randy Borton here tonight. Milkamania ain't running wild just yet. That new attire didn't help him out. Justin Sane floors Borton on the road to Ascendance, where he'll meet Brett Angel one-on-one. All these knees tonight from Justin Sane. Like he's channeling Scott Norrie. Borton try as he might, simply could not get an edge in this one. Every time he turned a corner, Sane was there with a knee to the face. Bring Rybak and the Ascension to CWA. Well, I don't know who Rybak is. I don't know who the Ascension is. And I don't know who CWA is, my friend. So I don't think I can help you. Justin Sane celebrates that victory, though. As we wrap up Genesis. I gotta let my dogs out real quick. Guys, gotta go outside. Go ahead. Go ahead, fam. Go outside, Ralph. And immediately they go out there and bark at something. I'm sure it's nothing. It's probably a fucking squirrel or something. What are you talking about, Tim? Hang on, fiddling with this wire again. Who's joining me on commentary? Yeah. I mean, you'll get there, Topher. It just takes time. All right. Let's see who joins me on commentary for this CMV.com exclusive live event. See if Timmy Boy the can join us. Come sit on my lap. My lap was cold last week, or earlier this week for the live event. Maybe Billy will join us again, perhaps. Topher's taking one of my strokes. He's a good guy. He was helping me out. He's helping carry the load. Papa bless, Topher. Papa bless. I mean, let's get Chris Andrews on commentary, though. Topher, where are you? All right, so far we got Tim and we got Billy in here. Billy, come on. Wow, Billy. let's see. I don't think Tim can put on a British accent. All right, I think this might be our crew.
Yo, this is Slick B, what up?
Slime B. All right, so we've got Tim LaFave and Billy Weaver with us here tonight. Good pals, you two are. Friends.
You too. I mean, sure.
Yeah, he's cool.
I like everybody.
Well, we talked about it at the last live event. Billy went on about how you helped him with Nick Blake that one time, trying to catch him as he was fleeing.
Oh, whoops. Yeah. I saw someone running, and I assumed they were a criminal, and justice must be served at all chances. So without thinking, I tried to apprehend whoever the hell was running.
And we ate Applebee's after that. We had a moment.
Did you kiss?
Had a steak tartare. No.
No. I ain't gay.
No, you know, I actually heard that Billy just sexually harassed the waitress. That's what it was.
Oh, yeah. I was unhappy about that.
I also beat Jerry Nelson Lawler's Jr. wife and blamed it on him.
We haven't seen Nelson in a while. His wife is like 20, right? I saw the picture. I was like, what? What is this?
27, something like that?
Fucking king, though.
Definitely rocking too it. Young to be dating that man.
She probably said, not tonight. You're gonna fucking fuck me.
He put a gun good. Under the table. It was like, kill yourself. That's the most literal sense of like.
She probably fucked up one of his Coca-Cola shit.
Carter's trying to
collect that shit.
Carter's trying to jump into my window. One of his little fucking dumb cat.
She ruined
Rex Carter,
one of his stylized Christian shirts that he wears. You know those fucking crosses he wears. When
yes, Rex Carter's trying to crawl through my window right now. I don't know what he's doing here. He's trying to get back on.
We don't even have windows in this place, man.
That's true. It's just a. You guys don't know this, but it's actually just a shipping container that we sit in. Commentate these live events. Is there any lights? We just sit crisscross applesauce in a circle around my laptop. That's all.
So about last week, that hooker wasn't dead. Beer told me she was dead.
Yeah.
So here I am, sitting here in the garbage. I'm walking away, and I just hear help. And like fucking four guys come to help her, but they wasn't actually helping her. They stabbed her and killed her. But they see me and they start chasing me down the street. And once I turned the corner, I started beating all their asses. That's fake. I made that up, but it'd be pretty cool if it happened.
It's a good story. I enjoyed it.
Well, to kick off this CMV.com exclusive live event, we got Nelson Jr. in action for the first time in a couple of months. We haven't seen him as he goes toe-to-toe with CMV Vet.
I forgot he existed. Was
Paul
he part
Anderson.
Of the fucking the company or whatever?
He was a big part of the. He was a big part of the rivalry of the year, Civil War, but after that, Triple H, you know, got put out of power, everything, you know, calmed down. He kind of just got lost in the fray, but he's back now.
That bastard deserved
it. A new look.
It.
Looks like he got a haircut. Got some dank fades maybe going on. Some X's on his hands. He looks pretty cool. I mean, if you got X's
and
on your
X's
hands,
though.
You're a pretty cool guy. So
they mean something.
Well, apparently sponsored
we'll
by Armorall as well. Yeah.
He's an X-Gen now, man.
We'll see what he can do against Paul Anderson. Of course, always joined by the 7-foot-tall Dwayne Dudley Devon Trayvon Smith Brooks.
And that nigger eats a lot at the catering.
Okay.
I'll tell you.
Billy, what did I tell you about using that kind of language? You're going to go back
little
to jail
fuck.
Again.
Nah, man, I didn't spit.
No violation. Your parole.
It wasn't on it, man.
Violate your racist parole?
Yeah, I didn't get no racist parole, man. I'd go get some more corn chips.
I've got a poop so bad right now.
Oh, there goes the cat. Ralphie, come on. Come on, Ralph.
So are we not going to mention this dude in a white suit right beside me?
Who's that?
Dinkle.
Dinkle, what are you doing here?
He's just sitting here pointing at me.
Oh, Dinkle.
I mean, maybe Dinkle is actually Fear, just in a costume.
Maybe Dinkle is actually Nick Blake.
Here, let's let a moth in, we'll see.
Nelson Jr., nice new theme to go along with his new look. I like it. Nice haircut. I can't get over those X's on his hands. He's just so cool. I don't know what to do about it.
I mean... He seems like the type of person that wouldn't want you to come into school the next day.
Nelson Jr. went unpinned for the first couple of months of his career. See if we can get back on track here. Certainly defeating the likes of Paul Anderson on your return. Can't hurt. Anderson returned himself, though, from a little hiatus with a win over. Who'd he beat? I just completely forgot the last live event. I think he beat Dregs, maybe.
Elijah Stewart.
I'm not sure. Did he? Was it Elijah? I don't know.
Nope.
Yeah, it wasn't Elijah. I don't know who. He beat somebody.
What does that tattoo say?
Dude, what does mine say?
Oh, I like you, Dennis.
Thank you. That's... What?
Aw, they're so friendly.
My first name's Dashing. My middle name is DJ. My last name's Yuri. He's gonna rip.
Well, I mean, when I'm not in the ring, I'm not a bad guy. I'm a pretty cool guy to hang out with.
And here comes Paul Anderson.
Mask and getting away
Paul Anderson embracing his black side here. These fucking dance moves and shit. He's going hard right now. They're thugging out.
Lost all respect for him.
He's a straight G. Here we go. What is sure to be an athletic matchup. Nelson Jr. and Paul Anderson go at it. Anderson, a seasoned. Don't pretty much say he's a season one veteran. A three-time world champion, two-time tag champion. This man main evented the first ever Ascendance. And I've been told that Paul Anderson and Dwayne Brooks will try to enter into the tag team turmoil match as they take on Vicious and Delicious on next week's Genesis. For another spot in that match.
So I was watching the show earlier, right? Who the fuck's Slick B?
Slick B was the... he had the potential to be the greatest superstar of all time, but, you know, drugs, man. They just got to him first. Just how it be sometime. Just how it be sometime, Young Thug, you know? Feel me?
I don't feel you.
So far, of course, we got the Briggs family defending their Tornado Tag Team titles. The Fast and the Furious World Tag Champs will be challengers, along with the Republic, getting a spot there by defeating the League of Dudes. Next week on Fusion, it'll be Doom versus Bromancers. And as we just heard on next week's Genesis, Vicious and Delicious versus Anderson and Dwayne. Oh, elbow to the back of the head of Anderson.
Oh, shit. Trying to snap his arm off.
Fan question for you, I believe, Billy, that says, would you rather poop Dashing's hair or eat Paul Anderson's hair? Please answer honestly.
What kind of faggot ass question is that?
Oh, that was an awesome spot right there.
These people on Twitter are always talking shit, making up weird ass fucking scenarios and shit.
Paul Anderson backing on a suplex attempt and then a heel kick to follow it. Oh, that was nice. Anderson also,
Paul Anderson's hair.
This season's the third annual King of the Ring.
It looks like that.
Anderson, towards the end of season two, was kind of like starting to fade out. The fans weren't really rallying, but the start of season three just came back with something new in him. Since then, though, since the coalition ended, right back to where he was, trying to rack up them wins.
We're going to make Paul Anderson great again, man.
On commentary with us is Tim LaFave and Billy Weaver, Michinoku driver by Anderson. Oh, what is Dwayne doing?
What the fuck is Michinoku
driver? Dwayne's trying to act sneaky. A man his size can't really pull off the stealth, though, as he tosses in a steel chair.
He's going to slide in a basketball.
Oh, what do we got here? Just stepping over the chair, does Nelson. Nice rolling thunder. Get some height on that. I just got a flashback of Caden Kinner.
Damn, kicking the back of his head on that steel chair.
IGF.
Oh!
Holy shit.
Oh, shit! That sell, though. Anderson's got the chair now. Referee's back is turned. And now what is he doing with the chair? Oh, okay. He somehow hit Nelson with it as he was tossing it out of the ring, so I guess it all works out in the end. Goes for the pin. One. Just a one count. Look who's joining us. Good old Slammer. That super kick sell, though, by Nelson. That was pretty nice.
I saw, his face was like, ew, on the ropes.
And then as he was throwing out the chair, I think he slit Nelson's throat. All these injuries tonight.
The list is growing.
Right.
Anderson awaiting Nelson to arise to his feet. What has he got in store for him? Snapmare by Junior. Into a reverse chin lock. And I can confirm, ladies and gentlemen, another participant added to the Slick B Memorial Battle Royal. None other than the man in the ring right now. Nelson Jr. going to get a spot. So that's five men now confirmed.
Wildly successful.
That's five men of the 20 now confirmed. Morgan Jackson, Xander Slate, Azrael, Shanaz, Andoni. And now Jr. as he goes to the top rope. Looking to take a risk. Will it pay off?
Seriously, who the fuck is
Anderson,
this?
Super kick! Catches him midair. Might have just screwed himself over. This isn't a rope break. No, it's not. Ref's going to count it. Oh, but still not a three count. This match continues. This is what makes him one of the
best in the business. That was dope, yo.
Nelson Jr. making a crucial mistake. as Anderson was playing possum. He's still in it, though. Still going as the youngster. The young lad.
Who's his dad again?
What's that?
Who is his father again?
Someone. His father was just Randy Nelson. I don't think it was anything like famous. I'm not sure.
he's just a junior. Short people. No, that's Randy Newman. Fuck it.
I think he's just rich. There's a rich boy.
Nelson trying to fight back to his feet here. Oh, goes for a super kick of his own. That should have hit. I mean, it connected. Man, it just didn't feel it.
I mean,
apparently.
You can't hit Paul Anderson with a super kick. He
just
can't.
It's not possible. He deflects all super kicks. Now a drop kick to the chest using the top rope is leveraged. Oh, Anderson up top might be cooking up a swanton bomb for his opponent here. Or perhaps Nelson's lying away with something. No, moonsault! Nelson's out of the way. Tweeter.
CMV is as... Will anyone ever hire that guy, Triple H?
Half Nelson backbreaker. Oh, big man. Dwayne Brooks distracting the ref by trying to pull apart the turnbuckle. Ref falls for it. Come on, John Cone. And Nelson has to release the pin.
Will T and Lee ever reunite? They were just
in never
they were just the match at Genesis. And they're gonna, I feel they're like gone. I announced that they're in a tag match next Fusion.
You don't know nothing.
Oh, Junior going for a finisher. Whatever he was going for, though. Scouted out by Anderson. Now a kick to the gut and a DDT. Oh, beautiful counter. Into a Northern Lights. I didn't see that one coming. And he got the three. What?
Oh, man.
Nelson Jr. counters a DDT with the Northern Lights, and I guess it caught Anderson off guard as Nelson gets the 1-2-3.
You know,
damn.
These are the times I just want to kill myself.
That's an upset.
Put out and grab the ropes.
Nah, he was in shock. He didn't see it coming. Nelson Jr. returning with a big victory for himself.
How hard is it to shift to the right and push your shoulder up?
Key counter brings him the win.
His legs were wiggling. This is a fluke.
Anderson just wasn't tall enough.
I think wrestling's fake.
Paul Anderson felt bad for his shitty career. And
come on, Sugar.
I'm gonna let you have this.
Come on.
Just this once.
Come on, Sugar. Sugar, where are you going?
I'm not your sugar, bitch.
You're a fucking dog. Sugar, come on. Hey, come on. This dog's irritating.
See, that's what I'm afraid will happen. When Sane fights Angel, is someone going to do a Northern Light suplex at the beginning of the match?
Oh, that was a nice finish. I like that. Key counter out of nowhere.
He was wiggling around.
He got caught with it. I mean, he had them shoulders pinned, son. Look at that bridge. Yeah, that replay shows that he was nowhere near the ropes. He was trying to kick, but Anderson wasn't tall enough. He's a short man.
His feet hit the ropes as he did that.
Darren, whatever his name is, Devon used his black charm to seduce Cone. He's like, look
who
at me,
the fuck
baby.
Gets Junior tattooed on his side? Like, that's the main accomplishment. That's retarded.
I saw this picture on, I was watching this video, and I saw this picture as a guy. It was like an interview. And you know how it said, like, his name, his age, and then, like, it said a bar, former child. It's sitting there like this.
Yeah, I seen that.
You saw that? Like, what the fuck? That's what I put on my resume. Alright, what are we going to do next? Let's have...
Let's have Billy versus Tim LaFave. We want to wrestle right now.
I was going to do something for a minute, man. I just completely forgot.
The ring's right there. I'm getting in there wrestling anyways.
I don't remember what match I was gonna do.
It's a fucking action. Let me wrestle ring, Dinkle. Dude. You remember where we are? Crate?
What's
yeah, the crate is
action?
Above the stadium. We're in the back of a truck right now.
I told you we're in a shipping container. Come on. Please remember.
Okay,
are we out to sea? I wasn't informed. I was black bagged here against my will.
I can't swim.
A random table match, says Lord Carnage. That's a great name. Gotta make that call. Lord Carnage. So we'll have Big Bad Briggs take on ? Sounds like a good match, right? It's time for her to make her debut.
Let's do it.
I'm a little upset they didn't use Cody Rhodes for the mystery.
Put her up against Nelson.
Thing. Oh no, that's not
they
a thing.
They did use Cody Rhodes.
No, I forget. For some reason, I thought that was actually the model they used for the mystery thing.
No.
For the question mark. But I realized you made a character look like that.
After Big Bad Briggs, Amber Briggs, fell out of the Queen of the Ring tournament by losing to Cassie Maverick earlier this week on Fusion, we'll see what could have been had she advanced and Alexia Stroud had gotten the victory over Megan Cooper. Got Stroud take on Briggs here. Juan on Juan. Stroud next week on Monday Night Fusion will take on Cooper to see who advances to the semifinals to clash with Cassie. And, of course, Tim, your mom, Cassifave, one-on-one with Fury in 2 weeks to see who advances to that semifinal match.
She beat her once. She'll beat her again.
Your mom?
Yeah.
We know the finals will take a place at Ascendance itself. Crown the first ever Queen of the Ring. Get a shot at the crown jewel the following month. But, Tim, we know. We just announced on Genesis after Kevin Lee's victory over Double J. You and Kevin, along with Jackson Jordan, challenging Chris Andrews for the international title in a fatal four-way. How are you feeling about that?
I'm honored and excited. But, you know, I'm not entirely sure what I did to deserve such an honor.
You're Tim LaFave.
I'm going to fight my hardest. Oh, bless. But, yeah, so and me and Kevin have discussed it thoroughly, and we said that despite us being friends and teammates, we're not going to hold back. And
yeah, that's what I
believe
said.
We said it best on Friday that it's coming home with one of us, and both of us are X-Gen, so at the end of the day, X-Gen wins.
Man, you gotta get meaner than that. You gotta say, I'm going in there.
Johnny Sampson.
I'm walking out with that damn championship.
This is the 2018 face of the year, Billy. I mean, come on. This is babyface
Tim. Yeah, but, I mean, you gotta have a little confidence. Not say one of us is gonna walk out. Say, I'm gonna walk out of that bitch with the championship around
my waist. It's
my
professional opinion that you can't predict things until they happen.
But you can have confidence and whoop ass.
I have confidence. I just don't know if I'm gonna win. I'm gonna give it my fucking
best,
but I'm not gonna.
Yeah, no. You know what?
Only
I wish we never went to Applebee's.
That they're gonna win before they win. You know.
Well, Johnny Sampson's trying to put together the biggest Ascendance card of all time, and so far he has not disappointed. Brett Angel, Justin Sane, Conor McGregor as the host, Slick B Memorial Battle Royal, and so much more. But he also announced on a Monday Night Fusion, of course. Billy Weaver, Nick Blake, one more time inside of a steel cage. But Billy, if you so much as spit in his direction, so much as even look at him the wrong way, until then, the match is off and you're going back to jail.
Hey, I don't know if I can deal with that. I'm going to go through withdrawals like crazy. I got to whoop someone's ass.
Well, you can whoop other people's. I'm sure you'll have matches, just not Nick Blake's.
I got to have five matches a night, man. You have no idea.
Do you wrestle your own children? Do you even have children?
I have a son.
Do you wrestle him?
No, I ain't seen him in like 6 years.
Holy shit.
Well, it's a funny story, really. Rex Carter's wife is my ex-wife.
It's okay.
So he has custody of my son. I don't give a fuck, though.
Well, we get this match underway as Alexia Stroud collides with Big Bad Briggs one-on-one. Briggs falling out of the Queen of the Ring tournament. Looking to bounce back, though. It's a win here.
Remember how strong Briggs started? I'm so surprised she's not doing so well anymore.
Briggs
bums me out, really.
Well, she's strong. I don't know if you meant that literally or not. Probably one of the strongest Vixens.
No, no, I meant like he started out as Vixens champion, very first one. Now she's fallen so far, and I'm so bummed.
True. She hasn't been doing so well. She hasn't been doing so well these past couple of months, but she still holds those two huge accomplishments. First ever Vixens champion, longest reigning Vixens champion, but certainly she wants to get back on top. Unfortunately, she's got to wait until after Ascendance now, and probably after the following pay-per-view, because Queen of the Ring is going to get the title shot, but you never know what's to come in the future for Big Bad Briggs, especially now that Johnny Samson is in control, and we know how much Samson loves them Vixens, so probably many opportunities coming their way. Yes, Alexa shouts in here, beating the shit out of Briggs right now.
Looks like she got slimed on Nickelodeon.
Alexa Stroud debuted. Nobody took her seriously. No, just glossing over her, dark horse.
She started using the Coney Island Cyclone. I mean, things are
she still uses
that.
It. She just won her last match off of it. Shout out. You know, she's a Big Tim fan. First couple of weeks of her career, taking a lot of losses. Since then, she's beaten the likes of Fury and Cass LaFave, and certainly beating Briggs here tonight would be another big win for her. Oh, those steel barricades. They're going to feel too good as Briggs gets smashed head first off of it. Stroud now into the steel steps. Jesus, what's Stroud got to prove here? My goodness. Going ham on Briggs right now.
She wants to be the best.
Putting over that young talent. And again into the barricade. Jesus, man. Briggs finally with a sign of life. There you go. Going for a crucifix on the outside. No, Stroud drops down behind. Oh, arm drag. That was a beautiful counter. Haven't seen that one yet. Tries to beat the count. Briggs ain't about it. Looking for that count out victory. Looking for the cheap win. That's Briggs for you. Oh, showing off her muscles. Well, she's got the time.
What else does she have? She's been getting her ass kicked all match. Of course she's going to take whatever opportunity she got.
Fucking dog.
Well, that's a Borton-style backsuspect right there. Oh, yeah.
Dang, 38 viewers. Hope you're all enjoying the show. This is the live
No,
right
no,
now.
They're all me. I made 38 different accounts. Bought 38 different computers.
Well, Genesis has come and gone. This is the live event. And then we officially begin our final stretch. 4 weeks until Ascendance, ladies and gentlemen. The grandest stage of them all, the fourth annual Ascendance. I cannot wait.
I'm counting way more than 38 people on the crowd.
You like what you see? Make sure you follow me. I do stream every Monday and Friday. Oh, what's this now? Lifting reverse DDT. Oh, brings her down hard. I'm sorry, Borton. I learned from you.
Does he still do that? Does Kendall Wolf still do the Wolf 5? What's his thing now?
Goes for the pin, lateral press, only two. What'd you say? Who?
What does Ken the Wolf do? Does he still do the Wolf by? The jumping.
The
DDT?
Wolf by? No.
Wasn't that the thing he used to call it?
I think that was just a regular move. This I'm not sure. He does an elbow drop nice when pulling out recently.
Yeah.
He won his most recent match off of a fireman's carry slam. Actually, move that you used to put on occasionally every now and then.
Oh, yeah. I'm a little pissed about that. You can't use my moves.
Kendall actually used it first. Way back when in season 2 before Tim came
the
along.
Long Island Slam first. Bullshit.
No, not the Long Island Slam. The Fireman's Carry Slam. It's like going for an FU if they slam on the other way. Yeah. Clothesline there off the rebound. Well, apparently we got reports of 38, 54, and 18. So, you know, whatever. However many people are watching.
I count about 112. You know, as a little kid,
certainly
Kendall Wolf. There's other guys fighting.
Kendall Wolf, since returning after 8 months out, winning the 2018 Royal Rumble, he hasn't been doing so well. Leading up to Ascendance, though. Wait a minute, Stroud just chilling, and here comes the Coney Island Cyclone out of nowhere. Briggs trying to roll over to the ropes, but Stroud dragging her away. Lateral press now.
One,
two, just a two count. It's a 62 for me now. If there is 62, if it says 62, that means there were 62 watching at some point. That's awesome. I hope you're all enjoying.
People don't always make accounts. They just
we're almost breaking the record. The most viewers we've ever had is, I think, 75 back when Cole Savage main evented in season 2. We just need like 12 more people.
Cole Savage back.
Just need Cole Savage to interfere
right
in the main event of Live Events.
Me
and
Deacon
will go in there right now.
Watch us right now.
Back suplex. Very back and forth match. At the beginning it was all Stroud, but now they're exchanging and Brooke somehow picking out that going down cyclone.
To get hit with the, yeah,
she woke up.
Cyclone to get back. Yeah. Most people, well, I shouldn't say that most people wake up because I really want to put them down when I hit them with that.
They will get 300. Yeah, I'm probably, I'd assume I'm number one now that Jackson stopped streaming, but I usually am. Unless there's some big guy streaming. He usually
Levi
gets like
Marta,
300.
Mari, Levi Marta.
Paul Heyman streaming now. He's a universe mode. Heyman hustle.
She starts playing with random superstars badly.
Good Bad Briggs fighting to her feet. Bad Briggs fighting to her feet. Whoa, that echo out of nowhere. Who just started echoing?
Not I.
I have no fucking clue.
Take your mic in and put it back out. Another counter by Stroud off the crucifix.
I don't even know what a mic is.
Swear to God, it's not me. Because I hear it too.
Shroud,
I'm not even wearing a mic right now. It's Dinkle.
Take the fucking mic
Dinkle,
out,
take off your mic. Take your fucking mic
bitch.
Off, Dinkle. I'm about to beat his ass.
I think Stroud was just about to pull a Brian Novak. Luckily, Briggs wasn't having any of it. Went out there and grabbed her.
He's pointing so intensely that it's in your ear right now.
I threw that KKK fucker out of here. Yeah, I'll be at the rally. All right, bye, Dinkle.
yeah, pick up and play WWE. I wouldn't buy this right now, though. Hey, Cowboys fan. Hey, Cowboys fan, since 17's coming out in just a couple of months, so. I mean, it's free right now for a couple of days, so you might as well try it and you can see if you like it.
Hey, man, this game is awesome.
I think it's like 23 bucks right now, so it's not too bad.
What the fuck game are y'all talking about? We're sitting here watching this wrestling
we're talking about
a game.
We're talking about CMV 2K19. You know?
18.
Yeah, but you're like talking to someone. There's no one else in here.
Yet, you fucking idiot.
Who the
it always
Cowboys
goes,
fan?
Oh my God,
I ain't a Cowboys fan.
The years are always 1 year ahead. Come on, Tim. Oh, wait a minute.
No.
Briggs.
We've been on.
Thumbs down. Looking for that boss bomb. She's going to lift her high up into the air and slam her back down again, splitting them legs.
I like leg splitting.
I like splitting.
It's over.
Lateral press, 1, 2, 3, and it is over. Big Bad Briggs getting the win.
Yeah.
Speaking of legs, yeah. I like all sorts of legs. Straw legs, chicken
fought.
Legs, turkey legs.
Hard fought battle, very back and forth. That was a really good match. Stroud, unfortunately, taking a harsh loss. She goes into her Queen of the Ring tournament match against Megan Cooper next week on Monday Night Fusion. That's not good for her, but Briggs rebounding. From her loss.
Is Manface McGee still kicking?
Manface McGee? What? Who's that?
MMA bitch. What's her name?
MMA
Casey
bitch.
Woods?
Casey Wilson? Yeah, she That's has her cool. her Queen of the Ring tournament matches in 2 weeks. She takes on Aura. Yeah, she's still kicking. what did you call her? MMA bitch McGee? Is that her nickname?
No. Manface McGee.
Oh, Manface McGee, okay. I think she does do MMA though, so either or.
You know, Vlad, man, I'd like to have a match, but I think I'm just going to stay here and just commentate. You know, just.
Really? I think the crowd's
see what's
gotten
going
a lot better.
Watching from the sidelines.
But by the way, Bill, how was Blake's apartment? Was it nice? I'm afraid you might have a better one.
What?
How was Bill's apartment? How was Blake's apartment? Was it nice?
It's not nice anymore.
Yeah, it was pretty nice, but his garden.
Here's your winner.
Like, you know how like people have all sorts of shit for it, like all sorts of tools and stuff. He just had it all splattered all over, like a storm hit it. I was kind of unimpressed because I figured he'd be a good guy, like you know, have some good flowers and stuff in his backyard.
Right, right. Well, I have a nice zucchini patch, but I haven't been home to work on it, so you might be disappointed by it. Please don't wreck my house because my zucchini patch is poor. But
I went ahead and pissed on his garden. I came back.
You got a bladder infection or something? Why are you peeing so much? Peed in his pool as well.
I drank 3 12 packs that day. I had the piss.
And you ate all of his turkey, so.
Oh, that's
probably
cold,
had to take
man.
A shit too.
Come on.
I mean, the turkey was pretty cold too.
I assume it was. What was he doing when he got there? Was he just watching TV or some shit?
He was doing.
He was watching Top Gun, and then had some camera guys set that shit up. And I was in there the whole time.
You lurking?
Yeah. I could have sworn that fucking window was a sliding door.
I don't play online a whole lot, Bibbs, so I wouldn't know. I mean, it's fun if you're with friends and there's no lag, but there usually is always lag, so. Big Bad breaks with that nice victory as we get on to our main event of the live event.
It was good when there's like a lobby system.
Remember when they tried to introduce a rumble? That was awful. That was literally the worst idea.
We all tried to play it. Yeah. Who the fuck is this on my seat? Well, they call me Batman. Get the fuck out of here. Alright.
Who are all the... Why? How are all these people getting in here? Dinkle? This Batman guy?
I left the door open.
I don't even know how that dead hooker guy here, the other... the other show.
Fear about that bitch in here.
Just all this... Somebody put her heels back on, at least. They're laying on the floor. They smell.
I don't think they're boring. I like these games. I always like the games, though. I just wish they would add that story designer. Sorry, I'm fiddling with my mic right now. You guys don't have to keep telling me how many people are watching. I can see it up in the corner of my screen.
Oh, we're still streaming? I thought that was the last match.
No, there's still the main event of the live event.
You used to only stream one match.
I think we'll see.
Who the fuck is this in my seat?
Good old days.
I'm Batman.
Makes TM be great again.
Ralph, don't think about it.
Makes TM be great again. I know it.
Oh my god, it's Billy Weaver, Zach. Come on. Yeah, the man with the best period can have a match. Let's throw Dregs against Andrew Briggs. Have a light heavyweight title collision here.
Oh my god, stop asking things.
Andrew Briggs does indeed need a challenger for his light heavyweight championship, as Shanaz Andoni's not getting a rematch clause. So perhaps Dregs, the newcomer, get a big win over the champ here tonight, put him, you know, right ahead of the pack, next in line. Ascendance awaits 4 weeks away. Big opportunity for this young man. Sugar's barking from outside. Ralph, simmer down.
He immediately barks after you say that.
He's not cool.
He's like, fuck you.
Yeah, he has a nice beard. I can dig it.
Probably not going to be downloading a new Andrews until Ascendance, honestly, since rivalries are going to start now.
It's just fading different colors. I don't like that.
What?
Actually, his beard is
lettuce
fucking
head guy?
Stupid.
That was a good...
That's
yeah,
a beautiful beard. Greatest beard
These
ever.
These guys bathe in mustard before they all got married. All
right, Dregs one-on-one with Billy Weaver. Forget Nick Blake. At Ascendance, loser shaves their beard. That's what we're going to see.
Ooh.
Well, that was quick.
I shaved my beard. I'll just grow back another one in a week.
He just puts his thumb in his mouth and blows, and it just comes out.
So, are we still set for Applebee's?
I mean, I can just delete the face paint, yeah. Victor, if you don't want him to be.
Man, I'm not getting that salmon again. They fucked up last time.
Are you still going to hit on the waitress?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to hit on the waitress. What kind of question is that?
Here he comes, stroking that fucking work of art.
Is Lee in town?
Lee and Kevin Lee?
Yeah.
He's probably in town. I think we're in the same town that Genesis was in, so I'm sure he is.
I mean, I really wasn't asking you, asshole.
Okay, jeez. You know what, Billy? I don't like your attitude.
Well, I'm sorry. I've been out of beer for the past week.
That's actually
my new girlfriend's trying to get me to cut down on beer.
Did you slap her?
No,
that's
I don't.
That's the appropriate response.
I'm gonna get. I'm gonna get some beer out of these. As long as you drive. All
right.
Certainly. I can't get no DWI.
We can take
DWI,
my Prius.
DIW, what the fuck you call it?
Huh? DIW.
Who the hell's in here with us?
My mom
some
just walked in.
Girl.
Some lady just walked in.
But man,
heard sushi sent her some flowers. What a nice guy.
Mom, with my friends.
Room.
Man, y'all see Nick Blake on Twitter a while ago talking shit. He was talking shit about this William guy.
Oh, okay.
I don't know who William is, but Nick Blake needs to quit talking shit about people.
Is it true your middle name is Rutherford? Because that's pretty fucking cool.
Huh?
Is it true your middle
you
name
think
is
Briggs
Rutherford?
Looks like Donald Trump? He looks like Donald Trump's son. I don't know what the son's name is. Idiot, I guess. Retard.
Andrew Trump.
Idiot.
Well, here he comes nonetheless, the light heavyweight champion. Ready for action. This is the first time we've seen him since Purgatory, I think it is. He was scheduled for a match on Fusion, but of course, web member Jeff Wallace ended up, or I should say Adam Bradley,
yes,
getting
yes,
mixed up. Brutally attacked
over
Hayden.
90 overall.
So the match is called off.
And he wears blackface and he don't get in trouble. I wear it once and I get kicked out.
Does he have an SMG in that trench coat? I'm a little worried for the people in the crowd.
He and Christopher Ann are gonna make a team. It's going to be called Don't Come to School Today. You're pretty cool. The music just
probably
stopped before the entrance ended. GG, sound guy. Oh, 70 viewers. It says on my screen, five more. We tie up our all-time record. Everybody go make bots real quick. Go make other accounts. Need to break that record real
They're
quick.
They're all coming here for me and Tim LaFave.
I don't
Not
doubt
you.
It.
Not
great.
You, Dennis.
Yeah.
Damn. You gotta do that to me. Oh, yeah, just shot
go.
Back down to 52 for me, GG. Rest in peace. It got to 70, though.
I heard
though.
This voice and
like,
nah,
it got to 70. We were close.
There was a moth, so they all left.
It was 20 fear accounts, so you just logged off real quick and handled it.
The hell, though. Man, come here for a moth, man.
Main event of the live event. Light heavyweight collision here. Dregs the big opportunity to shoot right to the front of the line. Andrew Briggs' title picture is wide open. Shinazzy Andoni not getting his rematch clause.
Really
Ascendance 4 weeks away.
He really should save the paint for the pay-per-view. I mean, what's going on, man? This is a live event. Why are you getting all dressed up?
Right.
If I was ever on a live event, I would be wearing sweatpants.
Who is this Finn Balor? Actually, I can't say that because Finn Balor has been in CME before, so we do know who Finn Balor is.
Really?
You can say it. There's another promotion called WWE.
Yeah, the first season
of... A lot of people go to that, but they act like it don't matter here.
The first season of Cops NXT, Finn Balor was there. It was Ryan's call.
Watching Money in the Bank
this Sunday.
Didn't you
have Kevin Owens at the beginning of CMB, too?
Yep.
Wasn't that a thing?
Kevin Owens and Finn Balor.
You Dean Ambrose win the Money in the Bank.
Probably not, Victor. That's probably not what's going to be. I mean, maybe a number one contenders match for Dregs. Very well, that could happen. I don't know if you just get a title match right away. He still hasn't made it off the live events. Certainly this win will probably boost him up to Genesis at least. Without a doubt.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Dregs started off his CMV career a couple of weeks getting a lot of wins, but then he met Mighty Dude and Wonder Dude, and he suffered his first loss.
Yeah.
And then, of course, he took a loss to Paul Anderson
yeah,
earlier
I'm telling
this
you,
week.
Man. I wonder, dude, that what happened with them today? They just got their asses whooped.
It was because Mighty Dude was not enthusiastic in his fucking dude chants.
He's had a lot going on. That, you know,
I know, but you gotta be at your best
kind of
when you're in
CMB. Dude, his grandma passed away this weekend.
I just had a shake.
Oh, shit. My condolences.
I didn't eat either.
Let's go get some Applebee's
Let's
after this.
Let's have some corn chips.
No. It's just me and Bill here. You're not invited.
Wow. I'll go to Applebee's. I'll sit on the other end. You can't stop me.
With your mom here.
Yeah, I'll go at another table.
You with your
me,
mom.
Me and Drex are going to grab some Applebee's. Forget you.
Dude, you're just killer vibe, man. Picking up all the waitresses.
Ooh, goes for an elbow drop. Misses horribly, though. Drex going to look to take advantage here.
But Mr. Tim wants to leave a $100 tip.
I mean, what do you think
all
I
that bitch did was serve our food. She didn't talk to us or anything.
Well, fifth annual Money in the Bank ladder match. It's way far. We've still got 4 weeks till Ascendance, but Battle Scars, the pay-per-view following Ascendance, fifth annual Money in the Bank is going to go down. So don't got to wait too long. Oh, Briggs, what's he going
that
for here?
This Sunday, WWE.
Hammerlock Lariat by Briggs there. It's a new movie he's pulling out as he shoots the half. One, two. Oh, close, but no cigar. What's up, WWE US champ?
Oh my god, Callisto joined the fucking chat. Can you believe it? Look at him.
What up, Callisto?
Hi.
What up, fam? Callisto's not US champion
Callisto
anymore, though. That's Rusev.
No.
Yeah, man.
Callisto's a real US champ.
It's Titus O'Neil.
It's gonna be, I hope so.
Whoa.
Probably get suspended again.
He's gonna win the title, go backstage and push Vince McMahon. He can get fired this time.
He's gonna look,
Johnny Sampson.
He's talking
like,
to me.
What the fuck is wrong with you? Which is funny. I was watching What Culture video and they had a picture of R-Truth laughing hysterically with Vince McMahon. I'm like, that doesn't seem right. Did someone Photoshop that? Like, this just doesn't seem something that would happen.
Where have you been? That's been around for like ever.
What was the?
Why is everyone being so hostile to US champ? Topher, especially, you know this guy? Is this a rivalry here or something? Oh, cross-legged fisherman buster by Dregs.
Tomcat with a vicious and brutal Dorito. I mean, you can't.
Well, that's sad.
He ended it all. He said, that's my name color. Bitch. Fucking throwing Doritos at him and shit.
Is it because he's the US champ? Come on, Topher.
He wants it.
Oh my god, 74 viewers. 74 viewers, it says on my screen. Oh, two more.
Don't say that.
49
on
mine.
Oh, I was
going to say 49. Dang, keeps getting so close. It's getting closer and closer.
Oh, it's 77.
No, it doesn't. Is it really?
I am not even kidding. It's 77.
Oh, it is. We did it. We broke the record. 77 viewers.
Yeehaw.
Yo. We did it.
If I had an air horn, I'd blow it right now, I promise you. But if I had an air horn, I'd
this
blow
is the
it
last
right
match.
Now.
He wasn't even talking to you.
Oh, was he talking to his fucking mom? Jesus.
This is a legendary day, ladies and gentlemen. We've done it.
Oh, shit. So, Dennis.
You should have fucking said, huh, mom? Not fucking, huh?
Yeah.
Tim, you're
hey,
my
Dennis,
mom.
Hey, what's your favorite place to eat at? You're a big boy. You like to eat.
Applebee's.
Oh, okay. I was hoping you'd say something else. I'm like, hey, let's go there instead, Tim. But, you know, we're still going to go without you.
Ooh. I don't like you very much.
Yeah. Just burned your ass, man.
You'll get over it, though, won't you? I mean, you can step in that cage with me, too.
I mean, it's just Dregs in the main event. Everybody's coming to see that beautiful beard. I can't blame them. A beard 10 times more beautiful than Billy's.
You're just salty, ain't you?
Because he doesn't have a beard. He's got like some patchy fucking pedo stash.
I got a pedo stash. That's all I need. Tim. All right, look who's talking over here, Tim.
You're supposed to be a good guy, man.
Patchy guy over here. See you.
Yeah, no, at least I got hair on my upper lip and it goes down to my beard.
Oh, wait a minute. Dregs, looking to finish.
Yeah, Mr. Neckbeard.
Oh, going for a stunner. I haven't seen that freaking smackdown. Here comes the pain reversal, though. That was a bad animation. But nonetheless, Andrew barely saving himself from a stunner there. As we now
animation,
get a...
Ain't this real?
No, the worst animation is the fucking... Oh, that was terrible. But the worst animation is when they go for like the reverse DDT. They lift them up and they kick their legs for a second and then elbow them in the stomach and do a suplex.
Yeah.
It's the, like,
I love your
the
bears
most disgusting
too,
fucking thing.
Your bears are pretty cool. Dang, this guy just came in here with the fire saying I'm gay. I don't know how to respond.
Oh, dude, if I could... Hold on, let me ban him real quick.
Don't ban
him. Hold on, let me get that shit.
He's okay. No.
Ban's ass.
He's good.
No, Ban.
You gay, LOL.
Jural. Oh, 970.
That's there awesome. There
we go. Let me make sure I got that
type
right.
That guy's awesome.
Oh, zero.
No, keep him, man. Keep him. It's over. Nope.
Confirmed. Topher versus U.S. champ in Ascendance. It's going down.
I know what you're saying.
Topher, what if he called you gay? Bet you wouldn't like it very much.
In the NXT
Damn,
chat,
tell
you'd be
Topher
like,
to go ban, home.
Ban, you'd start crying.
Ban.
Just a two count. This is a good match here between these two. Drek's not
they're
giving up.
They're all, man.
He's like, when this show is more
Drek's
popular,
wanting to get on Genesis.
Than the fucking main show.
That's what it is.
How do you feel about that, Dennis? How do you feel?
I missed what you said because Billy wouldn't shut up. What'd you say?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. No, forget it. Are you sure you weren't talking to your mom when you asked that? Because I don't want to.
And your
like,
oh, yeah. that spinning Euro uppercut. Gonna catch Briggs. Might see Dregs take home the victory. Ah, close. It's getting closer and closer. Dregs with his hands on his head. Doesn't know he's got to do to take down the demon.
I mean, it's closer and closer.
Man, that paint ain't even fading off. What if that's a tattoo?
Like, he went fucking full on crazy with it.
Oh, Briggs again with this athleticism on display. That Whirly Bird head scissors. Shades of Ringo Max. Papa Bless. Rest in peace. Briggs going to bring home the victory after a hard-fought battle. And he does. A valiant effort by Dregs. But Andrew Briggs, the light heavyweight champion, going to get the victory.
Ooh,
kick off his reign the right way.
His legacy.
Two-time light heavyweight champion.
Former light heavyweight champion. I know what it takes to be the champion.
Yeah, weren't you the first?
Right there.
First
right there, he has what it takes.
I think Dreg's passion, the passion he showed in that match, I think he still deserves to get on the Genesis.
You know, I wasn't first ever, but I was first ever two-time light heavyweight champion.
That is true.
Okay. Was it Kyle James that was the first one? Who was the first one? I can't remember.
Yes, Kyle James was the inaugural light heavyweight champion. Papa Bless, rest in peace.
Yeah, I can't remember. I just remember beating some kid's ass. And
it got him dizzy, Mari. Dregs threw up in his own beard.
Oh, that's the worst.
Ziegler coming in here. It's the final match ends.
You ever get fucking chunks dripping out of your beard? You're just
I
want to kill myself.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this was a great episode. We broke our record by 2. 77 viewers.
Yay.
An awesome Genesis. A good live event, and now just 4 weeks away from Ascendance. If you're new to the show and you like what you saw, make sure you follow me. I stream every Monday and Friday, so the next stream is Monday. It's going to be Fusion at number 45. We're almost close to Ascendance. I'm so excited. What a card. Still so much to be announced. Who's going to challenge Andrew Briggs? We don't know. He's bullying the referee. Of course, the website for the show, if you want your call on the program, all you got to do is click on the link to the site. It's posted on my info section. Tim will post it for you in the chat room. I'll make it easier for you. You go to the site. You click on the link. You register. It takes 2 minutes. Make an account. Check out the site. Roster pages. Rankings. All that good stuff. Post your call's name in the waiting list with his tags. I'll get around to downloading him. All the past episodes of CMB are on my Twitch page. Check them out. They're pretty good, you know. 216 episodes now. That's a lot. A lot of hours. It's probably over 1,000 maybe even. I don't know. Count if you want to.
As much as you would.
But, I wish I was. I don't know if you're talking about 216 or 1,000. I wish I were 216, but you know what? We're going to wrap up this episode with some quotes as always. Tim, what do you got to say?
I say you should fucking buy the new edition of CMB 2K19 in stores now for $29.99 because it's sold like shit. Maybe next year. Bill?
Okay, what about you?
Tim? Dennis? Yeah. Don't come to Fusion next week, fam.